BC Sports presents the Broncos of Santa Clara against the Mustangs of Cal Poly in an NCAA Division II semifinal championship game. This ABC Sports exclusive is brought to you by Chevrolet, your Chevy dealer, with Chevette, Monza, Citation, and the new Monte Carlo. Chevy's up ahead for 1981. By Goodyear, makers of Arriva, even its footprint tells you it's different. By Lowenbrau, when you want the taste of a truly great beer, there's really only one. Tonight, let it be Lowenbrau. And by JCPenney, more than 1,600 stores throughout the nation. JCPenney Auto Centers and JCPenney Shop at Home catalog. Hello and welcome to a beautiful California afternoon for football. San Luis Obispo, midway in the California mountains, close to the coast, and a beautiful afternoon for football. The Mustangs from Cal Poly against the Broncos from Santa Clara. Hi, everyone. I'm Ted Dawson. Welcome to what should be an outstanding football game. Now I want you to meet a man who I've come to know and respect throughout the years. I followed him to the University of Utah. He was a great All-American there. I wish I could have followed in his footsteps because he was great. Welcome, Lee Groskopf. Lee, I'll tell you, if this game today is anything like the game these two teams played earlier this year, we've got a great one.
Well, that score was just as close as it could be. It was actually a classic, 42-28, and I think it was probably even closer than that score would indicate, because up until the final moments of play, the outcome of the contest was actually in doubt. And in terms of statistics, it perhaps has to be a record-breaking day, one of the most prolific offensive days in NCAA Division II history. Over 1,000 yards of combined total offense, as you look at that graphic, in that October 11th meeting. So, as you say, if it's a rerun of that contest, we have a barn burner.
Coming onto the field, the Broncos from Santa Clara, ranked 7th in NCAA Division II.
There you see their record on the right, 9-2. That's including the postseason, 8-2 for the season. And they have come on strong.
And the Mustangs from Cal Poly San Luis Obispo, currently ranked 4th in the NCAA Division II.
They are right at the top of their game after that win last week over Jacksonville State.
An excellent ball game today. Expected both teams pass a lot. Both have exceptional passers. Henry Alfaro is a great passer, Dave Alfaro, rather, a great passer for Santa Clara, and Johnston is a great passer for Cal Poly.
Well, you know, we have an interesting story in Division II because it started with quarterfinal actions, and there we look at the pairings in the NCAA Division II quarterfinals. That all happened last week. That narrowed it down, of course, to four teams, and this is what happened last week. Cal Poly, of course, the winner over Jacksonville State, 15-0. And in a cliffhanger, Santa Clara won the ball game against Northern Michigan as Dave Alfaro in that ball game threw three touchdown passes. That brings us down to today. Now, Cal Poly against Santa Clara. Earlier today, Eastern Illinois walloped Northern Alabama 56-31 in a wide-open scoring contest there. So, today's winner will play Eastern Illinois in the Zia Bowl. That is for the Division II National Championship, and of course that is in Albuquerque last week, and a championship will be decided on the field.
We'll be back. We'll have the kickoff to today's game. You stay with us because we got a great game for you from San Luis Obispo coming up right after this. Hey, I'm Ted Dawson along with Lee Groskopf. Santa Clara has won the toss. Check that, Lee. They've just now given us a different movement as to who won the toss. Apparently, Cal Poly has won the toss. They're going to be defending the goal to your right. Cal Poly in green, Santa Clara in white this afternoon. The key players for this afternoon's game, you'll watch them. Watch them here, Lee, because they have some excellent. Dave Alfaro, number 10, the quarterback of Santa Clara. He is a great passer.
He can throw, and he is basically a drop-back passer, and he likes to throw the ball to this man, Perry Parmalee, number 81, who Pat Malley has said is the greatest receiver they have ever had at Santa Clara.
A junior college All-American. For Cal Poly, they've got what they call the 5-7-9 combination.
Robbie Martin is part of that five. He's number five, and he is the leader in career receptions. He also doubles as a threat on returns. Number seven is Craig Johnson, who patterns himself after Pat Hayden. He is a guy who can throw the football on the move or standing still. Here is the career rushing leader, a Division II All-American. Number nine, Lewis Jackson, and he is a breakaway threat.
We're ready for the kickoff here in San Luis Obispo. Number five, the fellow you just saw, Robbie Martin, is the guy who'll go back deep. And he is an excellent punt and kickoff return man.
He is a burner with about 4.5, 4.6 speed in the 40. He's dangerous every time he gets his hands on the football and will hurt you a lot of different ways.
He averages 25.9 yards per kickoff return.
Speaking of Division II All-Americans, here is another one. There are three Division II All-Americans on the field today. Brian Sullivan, one of the premier kickers in America today.
Mike Bush, number 81, back deep with Martin. And I would imagine Sullivan will try to kick it away from Robbie Martin because he is probably the fastest man, well, definitely the fastest man on this field. Ryan Sullivan, number two. Robbie Martin, number five. There you see it. 25.9 yards of kickoff return. And we're underway here from San Luis Obispo. Deep into the end zone. Bush fumbles it there and decides there'll be no run back. The quarterback for Cal Poly San Luis Obispo, Craig Johnson, out of Whittier, California, 5'10", 175. Dan Craig is a fullback, 5'11", 200. He's primarily a blocker. This is Lewis Jackson, 5'11", 195-pound tailback. He's averaging 5 yards per carry. Johnson sends Tim Hannafin out to the right side and puts Robbie Martin in a slot on the right, and that's Martin in motion. Jackson trips over the 20-yard line and goes down after about a 3-yard gain. Number 52, Mike Zinda, just a freshman from Upland, makes the tackle. Tim Hannafin, Brooks Wise, the tight end. Hannafin's one of the wide receivers, and here he is, Robbie Martin, the outstanding flanker from Orange, California. I tell you, Martin is really a superb football player. Wait till you see him, Lee.
You notice they're shifting him around. They expected double coverage on him all afternoon, so they're going to be trying to shift him around to get that single coverage if possible.
Martin in motion again.
There it is.
Now Hannafin splits out. That's Martin in a slot on the right side. Right up the middle to Craig. 40-yard line. And down at the 45. Danny Craig, who only averages 5.7 yards a carry. He's only carried the ball 38 times this year for 215 yards. Breaks it for the 22 yards in the first down. You see the defensive line for Cal Poly. Rod Shaw, excellent center. All right, I checked that this is the offensive line. Mike Dom, his brother also plays a lot. Rick Jones, a big right tackle. 6'4", 225 pounds. Martin, in motion again. Give to Craig again in a big hole and a trap over the middle as he crosses the 50-yard line down to the 46 where Jeff Harrison, number 7, makes the stop.
One of the things Joe Harper told me yesterday when I talked to him is that he wanted balance in his attack.
You take a look at the defensive line there for Santa Clara, just a 3-man line. Good, excellent linebackers. Mark McAtee, Dave Ramona, the best linebacker on the team. 105 tackles this year for Ramona. And a pretty good defensive secondary. Three interceptions for Schatzman, three for Lane, and three for Harrison. Again, Martin goes in motion, now sets up on the left side. Fakes the give to the fullback. Johnson is looking to throw. Plenty of time, throws it in the crowd, and broken up by number 3, Andy Schatzman. Harrison came up with the ball, but he was out of bounds. That's Jeff Harrison, number 7, a junior out of Goleta.
It appeared momentarily that we had the first big turnover of the day. Harrison seemingly had an interception. Johnson throwing that ball on the move out of play-action passes. And that's primarily what they will do. They are basically a play-action sprint-out or roll-out type of passing team. And they are basically a very well-balanced team between their running and their passing game.
Dan Craig is taking them down to about the 46, 47-yard line on two excellent runs because probably they're keying on Jackson. Second down and 10. Craig fumbles the ball as he goes into the line. Stop there made by Padilla and Scott Garfield. Also Dave Schoenack, number 88, and off the bottom of the pile.
You just made an excellent point. They are keying on Jackson, and they're also keying on Robbie Martin. You can figure that he's going to be getting double coverage most of the afternoon. That should leave Craig open running tackle to tackle.
Dan Craig has carried three times for 31 yards. Fourth down, still a yard to go. down for Lewis Jackson.
There you see the numbers on Jackson. 1,424 yards, a 5.0 average, 12 touchdowns this year. He is a bona fide Division II All-American. He carried as many as 55 times in a single ball game
against Boise State earlier this year in a big win for Cal Poly, I might add. First down from the 42-yard line. Three-man defensive line for the Broncos. That's Martin in motion. The pitch to Jackson. Jackson turns it up at the 40, still on his feet, and down right there at the 40-yard line on a good open field tackle by number 52, Mike Zinda. Zinda, just a freshman, 6'2", 220-pounder after a three-yard gain. Zinda, by the way, has a father who's a college coach at Claremont down in Southern California.
And they feel that Zinda is perhaps the finest freshman they have ever recruited. He is a player with unlimited potential, 9'9", and 100-yard dash.
And 4'5", in the 40, which may be even more impressive.
And he's 6'2", 220. So Mike, that tells Zinda, he's a hoss.
Second down, 7 yards to go as Hannafin splits out wide to the right. Martin is a flanker on the left. Back to pass is Johnston. Plenty of time. Throwing across the middle, complete to his fullback, Craig. Craig at the 30 and down at about the 27-yard line. Dave Ramona, the leading tackler on the Santa Clara Broncos squad, makes the stop. Ramona comes into this game as we take a look at Dan Craig. Ramona has 105 tackles on the year, a 12-yard gain. Johnston to Craig. Craig had caught only two passes all year long for a total of 17 yards.
And suddenly he emerges as the hero early on in this ball game, being the most prolific rusher and receiver.
Craig Johnston out of St. Paul High School in Los Angeles. Woodier, as a matter of fact. They give us to Craig again on the trap, and Craig finds a hole as he breaks his way down near the 20-yard line. They'll give him forward progress to about the 22 before Dave Padilla, the middle guard, the nose guard, who got pushed clear back, makes the stop.
Craig is running right behind a good one. Number 66, Mike Don, probably the toughest man along that offensive wall. They like to run the right side, and they've got the combination of Mike Don, number 66, and number 79, Rick Jones, who was a tight end.
Number 87, Mike Gilmore, splits out wide to the right side. He goes in a slot on the right. Now that's Gilmore in motion. The give to Jackson. Jackson runs over people down across the 20 to the 17-yard line. Number 52, Mike Zinda in on the stop, along with Mark McAtee.
That is the blast or isolation play, and it's probably the key play for the tailback in the I formation. Once again, as we look at more numbers on the great number 9, Lewis Jackson, career rushing leader for the Mustangs.
Craig Johnston. Jackson's carried the ball four times for 14 yards now. They give it to Jackson again. He turns upfield at the 15 on his way. Jackson. Lewis Jackson in for the score.
We saw him do this in a similar situation last week against Jacksonville State.
Lewis Jackson cuts right upfield at the 15-yard line.
This is Lewis Jackson's favorite play, the power pitch or student body left, where he gets it, follows it, he makes an excellent cut, and he's home free in for the touchdown.
Kind of an interesting spike there. He just lays it right down for everybody. Vasella to try the extra point. The kick is up. It's good. An 80-yard drive, 11 plays with 5:08, 9:52 left to play here in the first half. The score, Cal Poly 7, Santa Clara nothing.
Creations urges you to support this valuable part of education.
Ted Dawson along with Lee Grosskopf, and 9:52 left to play here in the first quarter. You see the score? There's the drive, an excellent drive by Cal Poly. We told you this would be an offensive battle as you take a look at Tim Vasella. He'll kick off back deep for, that's number 32, Forte. And 20 is Carey, Joe Carey. Vasella kicks it short and out of bounds. So a 5-yard penalty, and we'll take it again.
In thinking back momentarily, that was an impressive drive for the Mustangs. And talking to Joe Harper yesterday, I think the key word that kept coming up was balance. He wanted to have balance with his running game, balance with the passing game. So he got mileage out of his fullback and also the tailback.
There's the guy that's going to have to catch it up. Dave Alfaro, Jim Lane is in a starting role tonight, along with Tony Gahee, a former tight end. And now you'll see this man, Tyrone Forte, whose brother was a big star here last year. That's going to be the offensive backfield who's going to have to try to get even in this game. Bosella will kick this time from his 35. Carey and Forte back deep. Tom Bosella. That's Forte. The kick again fairly short. Forte will take it at the 16-yard line to the 25. Still on his feet, the 30. 35 and fights his way as he fumbles the ball, but recovered by Santa Clara. Number 71, Bruce Owen, recovered the fumble as Forte went down as he crossed the 35-yard line. Perry Parmalee, the outstanding receiver that Lee told you about earlier, and he is a great one. Greg Page is the flanker. Did not even start in high school, and Phil Otterson, the tight end, a 6'2", 200-pound senior. Dave Alfaro, 6'2", 190-pound senior out of Covina. Work out of the I formation. The motion is Page. The give is to Gahee across the 40 and fights his way to the 44-yard line. The hit was made by number 53, Jan Kirchhoff, and Ralph Gallagher finished him off. Interior line for the Santa Clara Broncos. Gary Hoffman is only 6'7", 250 pounds, and he's still a growing sophomore. Jim Goudreau, 6'2", 225-pound senior. Chuck Buckingham, 6'3", 235-pound senior. Tom Bordenave, 6'3", 235 senior. And Brown, 6'5", 240 pounds. Two big, strong tackles on this team. Second down, about 4 yards to go. Out of the I formation again, Alfaro gives to the second man through his tailback, Lane. And Jimmy Lane out of Oakland takes it across the 45 down near the 50-yard line as Kevin Reeder makes the stop, number 75, close to a first down. They got it. The defensive line, four-man line, Gil Martin, Dugan, Reeder, and Jerry Schmidt. Gil Martin, the leader there with 10 tackles. And excellent linebackers. Kirchhoff, the leader there, 93 individual tackles. Hasselberg, a great high school All-American. As a matter of fact, Lee, this guy had 282 tackles in high school in a three-year career. How's that?
Good numbers.
Dave Alfaro. As Page and Parmalee, his wide receivers, he drops straight back to pass. The pass complete to his tight end. Number 8, check it, that's his fullback, number 89, Tony Gahee. It used to be his tight end. Gahee moved to fullback this game, a 6-yard gain. Defensive backfield, Ralph Gallagher, a good hitter with 4 interceptions. Alarcio has 1 interception, and Chris Jones has 4 interceptions.
That's nice to have a fullback who's a former tight end, because you can put him on those routes, the flats, the swings, and sometimes also you'll run him deep.
6'3", 220-pound junior out of Loyola High School. His team was once ranked the number one high school team in the country. Second down and 4. Alfaro, the gift to Lane. Lane hits the hole hard before he's stopped by Jan Kirchhoff and Sven Hasselberg. 1 yard gain for Jimmy Lane, who moves into a starting role just in the last 3 or 4 games. As a matter of fact, he had 448 yards in his last 3 games.
That's an interesting number, because he had 577 yards for the season, 448 of those in the last 3 games. As a result of that, he has emerged as a key to these playoffs.
As you take a look at Alfaro's stats, very impressive, but as a matter of fact, even more impressive last year when he hit on 65.4% of his passes to lead the NCAA Division II. Third down and 2. The give on the delay is to Gahee. Gahee close to first down yardage and may have fought his way forward to the 40-yard line before Kirchhoff gets it, but not before Gahee gets the first down.
The second effort by Gahee is what did it. He really bucked and snorted there at the last as he got to the 40-yard line and just really carried a couple people over for the first down yardage.
Gahee coming into the game with 53 carries, 263 yards, 4.9 yards a carry, and only one touchdown. He's actually got, he does better on pass receptions with 20 for 226 yards. First down for Santa Clara. We promised you an offensive show. Fakes the give as Alfaro rolls out, throws into the flat, almost intercepted. Stepping in front was LeCharles McDaniel, number 45.
But Charles is pretty happy about that move.
Pass was intended for Page.
We're going to see play action pass with a bootleg by Alfaro, and he's trying to go to his wide receiver on the left. And watch LeCharles McDaniel with perfect timing. step in front of number 81, Perry Parvin.
Second down, still 10 yards to go. Alfaro, I think, is changing the play at the line of scrimmage. The give is to Gahee. Gahee crosses the 35 down to the 34-yard line. Jan Kirchhoff again with the stop.
Very possibly he was audibilizing that time, seeing something in the defensive coverage, which necessitated a checkoff to his fullback and 7 yards, once again by number 89, Tony Gahee.
Gahee has carried three times for a total of 16 yards so far.
So far we've had a battle of fullbacks.
Yeah. Two guys who weren't supposed to be carrying the ball.
Yep.
Barry Parmalee splits wide to the right side. The gift to Lane. Lane tackled by Hasselberg as he crosses the 30-yard line. Down to about the 29, a 4-yard gain. And very close to a first down. He got it.
Lane is a strong punishing runner with 10 flat speed and a 100-yard dash. And as you pointed out a moment ago, has really emerged in the latter part of the season and now becomes a key in the Division II playoffs.
Number 84, Kirk Fletcher, checks into the Santa Clara lineup. First and 10, 29-yard line. Alfaro back to throw. Across the middle, complete. Phil Otterson, number 85, takes it to the 20-yard line before number 58, Ben Hasselberg, the linebacker, makes the stop. Otterson just got married, as a matter of fact. Comes into the ball game with 281 yards and 5 touchdowns.
So that's part of his honeymoon, isn't it?
That's right. He had a back injury, interesting enough, back in spring training, and they didn't know whether he was even going to be able to play this year. He's been a tight end, he's been a cornerback, he's been a wide receiver. As a matter of fact, Pat Malley calls him the best athlete on the Santa Clara team. There's a pretty good athlete himself, Dave Alfaro. Alfaro gives to Lane. Lane takes it across the 20 down to the 16-yard line.
Alfaro is the leader in career passing yardage, and traditionally they have had great quarterbacks here at Santa Clara. Most impressive, of course, was Dan Pastorini, now a member of the Oakland Raiders.
Jim Lane with 7 touchdowns. You know, interestingly enough, against Hayward earlier this year, Lane had 114 yards in the first quarter.
That's moving.
First down, ball at the 16-yard line. Alfaro gives to Lane again over his right guard. Picks up a couple of yards before Hasselberg and Jerry Schmidt, the big tight end, make the stop. Give him a gain of 2 yards. Schmidt, a 6'4", 235-pound sophomore.
Running right behind Goodrow and Brown. That Don Brown is some kind of hawk. 6'5", 240. The Pro Scouts going to be looking at him next year.
Only a junior. Second down, 8 yards to go. Page splits wide to the left side. Parmalee comes to the right. Santa Clara moving towards the south here in San Luis Obispo. They'll fire the pass across the middle. Page complete at the 7-yard line. Number 45, McDaniel makes the stop. A well-thrown ball because I'll tell you, McDaniel was right on top of Page.
With double coverage on Parmalee, you can look for Greg Page to find some open areas today in that zone coverage. Watch him on a down and in route coming from left to right, and watch this pass. That is a curl-in route, and it has to be thrown with perfect timing, and the execution there was just right. Greg Page, number 8.
Close to a first down as you see the measurement. I'll tell you, you can't fault McDaniel that time. He was right on him, Lee.
This is going to be close.
It's about... Looks like an inch or so away.
You've heard the cliche, this is a game of inches?
Alfaro says it's an inch. The referee says it's 4 inches. Alfaro wants to go for it.
Well, like we say, it's a game of inches.
Third down and just inches. Ball inside the 10-yard line, very close to the 5. As a matter of fact, call it the 6.
Sometimes that's a good time to go for the whole thing. Play action pass and try to get it all.
Alfaro, 3 for 4, 23 yards so far as you take a look at Joe Harper, the head coach at Cal Poly. Alfaro takes it himself and picks up the first down. It'll be first and goal at the 4. Kaufman there to make the stop along with Kirchhoff and Hasselberg along with the entire defensive line. Covina, 6'2", 190-pound senior, straight-A student as you look at Joe Harper, the head coach at Cal Poly. 13th season, this man has never had a losing season here.
I was just going to say, never had a losing season, and in 1972 took his team to the Camellia Bowl where he had a close loss to North Dakota. I covered that game.
Who broadcast that game? Lee Grosko.
Along with Keith Jackson. First and goal.
They give to Lane. Lane over his left tackle. Fights his way down close to the goal line. They're going to stop him close right at the one-yard line as Mel Kaufman makes the stop, along with Kevin Reeder. Fletcher bringing the play in from the sideline. Replaces Page. This is Pat O'Malley in the white sweater. Pat Malley, rather.
The plays come in via messengers. The wide receivers are the messengers. Pat Malley sends the plays in. However, the quarterback does have the choice to audibleize, which he sometimes does. Not very often, but occasionally.
Second and goal. Split back this time. Alfaro takes it himself and is hit hard. But not before he got the touchdown. Dan Kirchhoff really leveled him right at the goal line, but Alfaro took it over. He gets a big hug from number 75, Chuck Buckingham, his center.
I like this. The old quarterback sneak, calling your own number when you're down in there.
One of
the
holes
that it does. Yeah, I don't understand the defense. I do not understand that defensive alignment. It's not good to have that kind of spacing when they're down that close. And one of the things he does is he reaches with the football.
Kirchhoff had actually stopped
to get it over the end line.
Brian Sullivan, who has hit 35 of 36 extra points this year, tries to tie it up. It's good. We're tied with 2 minutes 26 seconds left to play here in the first quarter. The score, well, tied 7-7. The Broncos won't buck. Okay? They did on that rally.
The Broncos won't buck? Or will buck?
15 yards, or 15 plays and 62 yards. The kick goes deep and out of the end zone.
62 yards in 15 plays for the Broncos, and that drive took 7 minutes and 26 seconds. We have seen two very impressive drives thus far in the football game. First by the Mustangs, later by the Broncos, and in both cases, balance is what sticks out. A nice combination of running and passing.
So Craig Johnston's turn. He had a spectacular 80-yard drive last time out using his seldom-used fullback, Dan Craig. They give us to Jackson. Jackson hit at the line of scrimmage, falls forward for about 3 yards. Number 88, Dave Shonak, makes the stop.
The Broncos have a 3-4 look to their defense, and as you pointed out, the key man really is that inside linebacker, Dave Ramona. He has been awesome. 105 total tackles coming into today's game. He had 16 tackles in the ball game against Cal Poly earlier this year.
That's Dave Shonak, the man who made the last stop, number 88. 6'2", 235-pound sophomore, is to give us to Jackson again. Jackson can't turn the corner. Excellent open field tackle that time by Greg O'Leary, number 39. Defensive tackle who is a former linebacker, high school All-American from Stockton. There's Lewis Jackson. 2 yard gain.
So now we have third and what appears to be an obvious passing situation. Let's see if Craig Johnston elects to go upstairs. His favorite target, of course, is number 5, Robbie Martin. But with the type of coverage we're seeing today, you may see him going to one of his secondary receivers.
Straight back to pass is Johnston. Johnson across the middle, Martin, overthrown and almost intercepted by number 31, Jeff Lane. Lane had his hands on it. He's the sophomore out of Saratoga.
Jeff Lane has been busy, 53 total tackles and 3 interceptions. He wanted Robbie Martin, but Robbie Martin again was covered all over the field. They told us yesterday when we spoke to Santa Clara officials that they could not let Robbie Martin have anything. They said that would be probably their main key.
Jeff Harrison back deep for the Broncos. Vassella to kick. Vassella averages 40.1 yards a kick. High spiraling kick. Harrison takes it at the 33. 35, fumbles the ball. Still nobody's got it. I'll tell you, a
lot of people had a shot for that ball, Lee.
Boy, that's a real razzle dazzle.
Santa Clara got it. 42-yard punt, a 7-yard return. We're tied at 7. Bill Alderson picked up the ball. We'll be back to see Santa Clara right after this. Tied with 101 left to play here in the first quarter. Lee, watch how many people have a shot at this loose ball.
Well, I counted 5. Let's see if I'm correct. 1.
Now 2, 3. Here.
2, 3. 4. And then
5.
Santa Clara finally comes up with it.
Otterson, number 85, finally comes up with a loose ball. First and 10. Ball at the 40-yard line. Dave Alfaro, who directed a great drive his first time out, has a little trouble getting rid of it. Gives to Lane. Lane trying to turn the corner. Can't do it on a great stop by Mel Kaufman, number 56. 3-yard loss by Jim Lane. And Kaufman, who's got one interception so far this year for a 79-yard touchdown, made a super tackle that time.
He was a busy guy in that ball game last week against Jacksonville State. In fact, all of the linebackers were. There's a comparison of the rushing yards for the two teams. Cal Poly dominating at this point.
Second down, 13. Dave Alfaro. You can bet anything you want, he'll pass on this one. Across the middle, complete to Page at the 49-yard line, but he can't hold on. You can't fault Dave Alfaro for that one. Page had it right in his hand. Are they going to give him the catch? They are. Lee, they're going to give him the catch.
That's going to be a very controversial play in this game because I have my doubts. Let's check the time of possession right here. Okay, Alfaro, straight drop back pass. He's facing a blitz. He gets the ball off with good timing to Page. Well,
no way.
I can't see it. I can't see
where
he actually had it. 12 yards on the completion.
Boy.
But he's lucky to have that one.
Absolutely. And that ends the first quarter here in San Luis Obispo. Ted Dawson along with Lee Grosskopf. We're tied at 7. We'll be back with the second quarter right after this. Tied 7-7 as we start the second quarter. I tell you, we promised you a good game. Lee, I think we're giving it to you.
Real even in that first quarter.
First and 10. Santa Clara at the 48-yard line. They get to Lane. The first flag. Fumble. Cal Poly's got it. Number 17, Dale Partha, who just checked into the ball game, replacing Anthony Alartio, has the ball. That was bad from the handoff right on out. Lane never had a shot at it and kissed it off right after he hit the line of scrimmage.
Dale Barthel, the backup strong safety.
Man in motion.
Very alert play.
Offense.
On that football.
Decline. Fumble recovery. First down.
That's your referee, Howard Rowe, telling you, obviously, that Cal Poly has turned down that call for the first break in the ball game. Actually, the second break, the first one went to Santa Clara on that pass completion.
That was.
Robbie Martin splitting wide to the right side. Tim Hannafin goes to left. Justin across the middle and complete. Intended for number 28, Tim Hannafin, as Dave Ramona there to break it up.
Tim Hannafin is Craig Johnston's roommate, and he told us yesterday when we talked to him that he could be the key today because he was anticipating double coverage on Robbie Martin. As we look at those stats, I anticipated this, that the total yards, as you see right here, are just about dead even. 85 to 70 in favor of Cal Poly. Time of possession also very even. Santa Clara actually holding onto the football a little longer. You take everything into consideration, it's just as close as the scoreboard shows.
That's Martin in motion. They give to the fullback. Craig takes it across the 50 down to the 48-yard line. Mike Zinda makes the stop after a 4-yard gain.
We're going to be hearing about Zinda for 3 more years.
Boy, is he a super freshman.
He is a player. And he comes to play.
A hoss, as you say, right?
Or a hoss and a half, if Keith Jackson likes it.
Brooks Wise checks into the lineup. That's Steve Arlotto going out. Now Hannafin and Martin both go out to the left side as you take a nice close-up look at Craig Johnson. Johnson being chased, throwing across the middle. Complete to Jackson. Jackson trying to break free, but can't do it. Out of the hold of Mike Zinda at the 45-yard line. Now a flag goes down, and they're going to call a foul against Garfield Scott after a gain of 4 yards. Watch it again, Lee.
Let's see if we can see the foul, and let's also watch the poise of Craig Johnson, number 7. He's only 5'10", but he has a strong arm and a lot of poise. He sets up well, sees that the primary receiver is not open. He finds Lewis Jackson, his tailback, who is circling out of the backfield. And did you see the foul?
Yeah, there was some a mix-up between Garfield Scott and number 65, Joe Pettit for Cal Poly. After the play, it was already dead, or after he'd already thrown the ball. So Tech on 15 yards to that penalty.
We got dead ball foul, personal foul, defense, first down.
It was called against number 63, Garfield Scott, because he pointed right to him when he threw the flag.
So you have a dead ball foul, personal foul.
First down at the 30-yard line. That's the first penalty of the game. That's Gilmore coming to the right side this time. The give to Jackson. Jackson stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Good charge that time by number 60, Dave Padilla. Also number 80, Tim Pesterisi.
Padilla and Pesterisi.
You gotta love it.
Sounds awesome, doesn't it? I don't want to run there.
What else from a good Catholic school? You had Notre Dame this afternoon?
All right.
And wide to the left, and Martin goes wide to the right. Good tight shot of Craig Johnson. Johnson rolling out the pass, throwing complete to his tight end Wise at the 21-yard line. Mark McAtee runs him out. Brooks Wise, a junior out of Palos Verdes.
This has been far and away the favorite route of number 88, Brooks Wise. Now watch Craig Johnson throw on the dead run here. He's sprinting out to his right. He keeps moving. He sees Wise running to the sideline. He throws that ball with perfect timing, and that is the way to throw an out pass to the receivers outside so he can take it and then step out of bounds.
Wise, just a junior, has one touchdown so far this year. Six passes for 71 yards. And now timeout called by Craig Johnson. He doesn't like what he sees. Johnson goes over and talks to his coach, Joel Harper, on the sidelines. We're tied here in the second quarter. 13:05 left to play in the first half. We're all tied up at 7 as you take a look at the Cal Poly Band. We'll be back right after this. Bo, you see the score as you take a look at the Cal Poly marching band there in the background. I'll tell you, they are regarded as one of the finest marching bands on the West Coast. You'll see them at halftime, so don't miss that. They are super. Third down, 2 yards to go. Johnston to Jackson. Jackson slaps over his left tackle and picks up the first down easily as he gets down to the 12-yard line before Jeff Lane makes the stop.
Lewis Jackson running right behind Brian Page, number 71, who really moved him out on that play. Let's see if we can watch number 71. Well, you don't really see it, but there is a good hole there on the left side. And Lewis Jackson showed you some of the moves that made him a Division II All-American.
And a high school All-American, I might add. Johnston gives to his fullback, and Craig didn't fool anybody that time as Greg O'Leary, the junior out of Stockton, makes the stop. Also, Mike Zinda, the freshman.
Craig O'Leary has been probably the most active of the down linemen.
This is Zinda, number 52, the freshman we were telling you about earlier. 6'2", 220 pounds.
Get to know him. He's going to be around for a while. He's already made 70 tackles, and he's a freshman.
I think his father might have coached him a little bit. I mentioned earlier his father is a college coach at Claremont down in Southern California. Jackson has carried 10 times for a total of 44 yards so far as Johnson rolls out the throw. Complete. Touchdown. Number 89. Brooks Wise. Was that 88? Brooks Wise. Brooks Wise, number 88, picks up his second touchdown of the year. Number 88.
Same play they came with earlier on the drive to get the first down, and they come right back with spread out action for the touchdown. Here it is again. This is what Craig Johnson does so well, is that he watches as he's moving. He sees the field. He waits, he waits, he waits some more, and he lets Brooks Wise, the tight end, clear out. And when he gets open, he fires that ball. That is a perfect pass.
Well, he just barely got that touchdown. He got one little toe inside. Vasella. It's good. 12:03 left to play here in the first half. The Mustangs of Cal Poly San Luis Obispo have jumped out on front after the fumble, 14-7.
Dad, watch the left foot of Brooks Wise, the tight end, on that last touchdown, and you'll see that he barely makes it into the promised land. Let's take a look at that left foot now, right about there. And you'll see that it's about as close as it can be. That's his second catch of the day, and he now has 22 yards on two receptions.
A 53-yard drive took eight plays after the fumble, 2 minutes and 52 seconds. Into the end zone and out. Forte will let it go, and Santa Clara will take over. First and 10 from their 20. I'll tell you, Cal Poly got a couple of big breaks that time. They got the fumble, and they also got the 15-yard dead ball penalty. Reminder, next Saturday, NCAA college football, live at 10:30 Pacific time, regional coverage of NCAA Division II championship. That's featuring the winner of this game right here. And then Division I AA semifinal games, Eastern Kentucky versus Lehigh and Grambling versus Boise State. Fumble again, but Santa Clara recovers.
The winner of this game against Eastern Illinois, who was a big winner earlier today over Northern Alabama.
Watch this, Lee.
Let's see if we can see how that fumble happened.
Forte never had a shot at the ball. He got a bad handoff from Alfaro.
Alfaro didn't really get that ball buckle to buckle, which is what they say the quarterback should do with his running backs.
Tyrone Forte, number 32, has checked in replacing Jim Lane at one of the running backs. The other is Tony Gahey. Alfaro the pass. Throws the screen, incomplete and almost intercepted by Sven Hasselberg. Number 58 was right there in the middle of that play.
Pat Malley is a coach that really likes the screens, the draws. He's really an advocate of wide open passing football. He told me yesterday he was very influenced by the philosophy of the Cleveland Browns. He was also influenced by Len Casanova. Let's take a look at the screen. One of the keys to the screen is that the linemen really have to be actors to set this up.
Watch Hasselberg. He's going to come from your upper left right there. He got right in the middle of that.
Yep. That's the place to be.
Alfaro on 3rd and 13. Plenty of time. Across the middle. Complete to Parmalee at the 34-yard line. But he can't hold on. Are they going to give it to him? They won't this time.
I guess they're trying to make up for the last call.
Chris Jones hit him. Thinks he should have the pass reception. He had to go high in the air, and when Jones hit him, he couldn't hold on to the ball. Alfaro is now 4 for 7 for a total of 34 yards.
This is one of Perry Parmalee's favorite routes, the curl in, and he appears to have the football as he comes to. Actually, I think that was more of a completion than the other one.
I'll tell you, Chris Jones gave him a lick, though. Wow.
He got a shot, didn't he?
Boy. Cunning is number two, Brian Sullivan. That's Robbie Martin back deep for Cal Poly. They kick it away from Martin. Gets a fair Santa Clara roll and goes out at the 45-yard line. 37-yard punt for Brian Sullivan. We've got 11 minutes, 5 seconds left to play here in the first half. Cal Poly out on top, 14-7. We'll be back in just 1 minute. And Cal Poly will have a chance to move it further.
Excellent field position right now for the Mustangs, and this could be a very important drive for them because the momentum seems to be turning their way. They have a 14-7 lead in the game. I wouldn't be too surprised if Craig Johnston comes with one of his big plays on first down, tries to hit the big one. Go for the bomb. Not
Johnston's
a bad time.
An impressive little guy, isn't he?
You know, as small as he is, he can throw the ball about 65 yards in the air if he has to.
5'10", 175 pounds. No big play here as Jackson gets it, turns the corner, and gains nothing as he's run out of bounds right at the 45-yard line. Chasing him out was Mark McAtee, number 65. Also, Garfield Scott in on the play.
There again, the comparison in rushing yards, and you can see that Cal Poly continues to dominate in that department. However, Santa Clara has the edge in passing, so it's been pretty much of an even contest. Historically, the Mustangs have been more of a running team under Joe Harper, but with Craig Johnson as their quarterback, they have thrown the ball more, particularly with sprint out or play action passing.
He's got Martin and Hannafin both split. Rolling out, looking to pass. Throwing complete to Martin, but out of bounds. And now a flag goes down at the 37-yard line as Jeff Harrison hit it. Pass interference, Lee.
I believe the contact by Harrison is going to be premature. Perhaps we'll have a chance to look at it again. But the contact cannot be made while the man is attempting to catch the football. Let's listen.
The call was made against Jeff Harrison. 17 yards on the penalty. Picks up the first down.
Defensive pass interference. First down.
Sprint out to the left. And I think you're going to be able to see this pretty clearly along the left sideline. See the contact? It is very close.
Pretty close.
First and 10, the pitch to Jackson. Jackson picks up about five before he goes out of bounds at the 34. Mike Zinder, the man running him out. 3 yard gain. Jackson's just a little guy, too. He's listed 195, but I think that's with full gear.
And weights in his shoes.
He's out of Fresno.
He's got some pro scouts interested, though, despite his lack of bulk.
The last time these two teams met, Lewis Jackson carried the ball 41 times for 231 yards. In that high-scoring game, Jackson got only one touchdown out of it.
And later, he carried the ball 55 times in the game against the Boise State.
For less yards. Craig finds a hole and busts his way up there, first down yardage before Craig O'Leary makes a stop.
There's the man that's really been the key thus far in the ballgame, though, is number 39, Dan Craig, the fullback. He's really gotten his tough yards inside.
A 7 yard gain and a first down for Craig. Craig is just a sophomore out of San Jose. He had carried the ball only 38 times for 215 yards and 3 touchdowns coming into
this. And has only caught the ball twice for 17 yards, so he already has 1 catch today and 6 rushes for 50 yards.
Jackson gets the pitch again. Gets a block from Craig. Tony Green ran him out. Gain of 3.
Gain of 3 on the play at the 24-yard line.
Second down, still 7 yards to go.
Second and 7.
10:20 left to play here in the second quarter. You see the score.
Good situation because it's a run or pass situation here.
Not when Lee Groskopf was quarterback, it wasn't. It was a passing situation. And Craig Johnson, the Lee Groskopf look-alike as he passes it right into the hands and out. The number 83, Rick Jones.
We did have that play at the University of Utah, as a matter of fact. Cactus Jack Curtis used to call this the old 39 running pass. He said that was the biggest lock in America. He said anybody can run that. You can run that play yourself, Ted Dawson. All right, here it is. He's sprinting out to his right. Fakes first to his tailback, Lewis Jackson. And once again, he scans the field and looks toward his tight end.
Rick Jones had a shot at it.
4 of 8 for Johnston now in the passing department for 37 total yards.
You know, Jones has 2 numbers. Jones is 79 when he's a tackle and changes to 83 when he's a tight end. The pass to Craig, he can't hold on. Dave Ramona with a good hit along with Mike Zinda.
We hit him in a bad place.
Well, Dave Ramona hit him in a bad place, I'll tell you that. He really put the stick to him. Dave Ramona will be back next year. He's a junior out of San Jose. 105. 105 individual tackles, had 16 against this team when they last met.
That's so they'll remember him.
Vasella, who is hit on 12 of 21 field goal attempts, will be shooting from the 31-yard line. This is well within his range. The ball is down. The kick is up. It's got the distance, but off to the right side. No good. The 41-yard field goal doesn't do it. So the score remains with 10:04 left to play here in the first half. The Mustangs of Cal Poly 14, the Broncos of Santa Clara 7. You stay with us. Want to pay to get in this afternoon. They're right out of their dormitory.
I don't blame them. Then we have some tree people.
Look at these guys. They really wanted to see this game. And they're seeing a good one. 14-7 here in the first quarter. 10 minutes and 4 seconds left to play.
First down, 44-yard
line. Dave Alfaro. I keep wanting to call him Henry, and I'll tell you why right after this play. The give to Forte as a flag is down. A flag down thrown by the head linesman, Tom Ellers, right at the line of scrimmage. Henry Alfaro is Dave Alfaro's father. Henry's office is right across from mine at ABC in Los Angeles. Henry is an outstanding news reporter in Los Angeles. I'll tell you, he is a great guy and the biggest football supporter for his son in the history of the world, believe me. He has followed his son to every game he's ever... You see the rushing yards so far. Cal Poly with their balanced offense. 5 yards tacked off on the penalty. It'll be first down and 15 yards as Dave Alfaro, Henry's son, brings his team up to the line of scrimmage.
I'm glad you cleaned that up.
God, I'm only calling Dave Henry all day. Dave to Parmalee. Completed the 30, but Parmalee can't hold on. Again, a great hit by the defense, number 20, Chris Jones. And that's twice Jones has stripped Parmalee from the pass.
It looked almost like an instant replay of the last curl-in route in which Parmalee runs the good route. The ball is on target, and watch Chris Jones, number 20. Okay, let's watch the style now of Dave Alfaro. He is a classic drop-back passer. He has a good high overhand release, and he throws this ball with a lot of authority. There's the catch, seemingly, but look at the hit. The hit interrupts the reception, and they rule it incomplete.
Good call. Chris Jones, a senior out of San Jose, has 4 interceptions so far this year, as Alfaro now is only 4 for 8, 34 yards. Again across the middle of Parmalee, this time he does not hold on again. Cal Poly is saying they intercepted, but the official run of the play says no. Edmund Alarcio and Mel Kaufman right there say no. The official says no. Alarcio got the first hit, and Parmalee is having a tough time of it. Watch it here, Lee.
Oh, this is what wide receivers hate, the down and in route. Sprint out to his right. Alfaro is going to be looking for Perry Parmalee coming from left to right on the down and in route. And there is the pass once again perfectly thrown. And what a hit by number 40, Edmund Alarcio, perhaps the best athlete in the secondary. And he got a little help from Bill Kaufman, number 56.
Alarcio's nickname? Headache.
Headache.
And now you know what?
Ball wonder.
Alfaro, who has missed 4 straight, goes back to pass again. Throwing, complete. And out of bounds is Forte at the 30-yard line. Ralph Gallagher runs him out, way short of the first down. Gain of only 4.
Headache Alarcio. Pass the aspirin, says Perry Parmalee.
I tell you, we have seen some great hits out here. Standing ovation across the field for the Cal Poly defense. And Lee, I got to believe they deserve it.
The Mustangs and the Broncos. We got some hosses out here today.
Some pretty good kicking. Brian Jackson back to kick. And that's Robbie Martin. Jackson again kicks it away from Martin. Good high kick. Out of bounds around the 25-yard line.
Brian Sullivan is some kind of kicker. Division II All-American.
A reminder that ABC's Wide World of Sports returns next Saturday at 5 o'clock Pacific time with a super featherweight championship fight from El Paso, Texas. Live, except on the West Coast, where you'll see it at 5 o'clock, WBC World Featherweight Championship, Salvador Sanchez versus Juan Laporte. Sanchez is 4th title defense, 36 wins, 1 loss, and 1 draw. We go back to the action. 1st and 10 at the 25. Johnston on the bootleg. Throw complete to Martin. Martin down by Harrison at the 49-yard line.
you can see why number five is the career reception leader for Cal Poly. This is the first look we've had at Robbie Martin in action today as a receiver. Sprint out once again. He has thrown to the tight end office. Martin is running a deep sideline route, and you can see the ball is thrown a little bit behind him. He reaches back. Harrison is right there with a kiss.
Martin takes a good hit.
He holds the shot.
First down, 49-yard line. Robbie Martin, you see him over there with Joe Harper on the sideline. Gilmore replacing him in the lineup. That's Gilmore in motion. The gift to Craig. Craig breaks the tackle at the line of scrimmage, but can't get out of the hole of number 62, Dave Ramona. Gain of 4 yards on the play. Watch a great second effort here by Danny Craig.
We have been talking about the effort of number 39, Dan Craig, this afternoon. Watch him as he just takes a little reverse handoff here by the quarterback, Craig Johnson. Now watch here. Boom! And he loses the first tackler. Wham! Pow!
Tony Green hit him first, and then Dave Ramona came up to finish him off. Second down. 7 yards to go. Make it 6. They get to Spiker. Spiker tries to turn up, gets a couple of yards before he's finally hit by number 23, Chris Lundy. Lundy, who was not supposed to play today.
Greg Spiker doesn't play that often, but he's a good backup to number 9, tailback Lewis Jackson. That time on the same play that has been so effective for Jackson, the blast play off the left side.
Spiker has a 49-yard carry for a touchdown so far this year, his longest of the year. Comes in with a total of 284 yards. That's his first carry of this afternoon's game. Greg, the only setback. Passing formation. Johnson rolls the pass. Plenty of time. Oh, the time in the world. Throws incomplete. Intended for Spiker. Broken up by Harrison. That's Greg Spiker, a senior out of Santa Ana. He's had 8 receptions so far this year for a total of 88 yards. Johnson is now 5-for-11 for a total of 55 yards.
That's been their most effective pass play all afternoon. They sprint out to one side and flood a zone, and they actually have. They've got a wide receiver going deep. They've got a tight end underneath, and then either a fullback or a tailback sliding out into the flat.
Tom Vasella back to punt on 4th down and 4. Harrison back deep. High snap. Vasella drags it down. Fairly short kick. Harrison calls for the fair catch and takes it at the 10-yard line. 34-yard kick, 7:31 left to play here in the first half. Let's go to this message from the NCAA. Homes of college football, 1980 style. Who's he taking a picture of?
Maybe of Ted Dawson.
Hi to you, too. We're in San Luis Obispo for a great NCAA Division II semifinal championship game as Dave Alfaro brings his Broncos from Santa Clara up to the line of scrimmage. The pitch out goes to Forte. Forte's got some running room at the 10. Cuts upfield to the 15-yard line. The Charles McDaniel out of Salinas makes the stop.
The Charles have been busy today.
5-yard gain for number 32, Tyrone Forte, whose brother Troy was the top ball carrier here a year ago, had 955 yards. But interestingly enough, Tyrone, who's only a sophomore, beat his senior brother out in spring training last year. And then Troy, who's his brother, got hurt in preseason practice this year. Tyrone Forte. 2nd down and 5. Alfaro gives to Gahee. Gahee breaks over the line of scrimmage across the 25 to the 27. Boy, he is a big, strong kid. Edwin Marcio hustles him down. Gahee, 6'3", 220, after an 11-yard gain.
Gahee is a big fullback, but occasionally you will see Forte line up at fullback himself, and at 160 pounds, he has to be the smallest fullback in America.
Santa Clara. Gahee has carried 4 times for 27 yards so far. Alfaro again looks like he's calling a play at the line of scrimmage. Sack! By number 63, Tom Sikowski at the 17-yard line. Nobody touched Sikowski. He came from his right linebacker position, and nobody came close. A 9-yard loss for number 10, Dave Alfaro. Sikowski, a 5'10", 190-pound senior out of Bakersfield.
Would you like to see the blitz defined? Watch number 63, right linebacker Tom Sikowski. Quarterback doesn't see him. There's always a blind side to the quarterback.
Alfaro did an excellent job for not fumbling the ball.
Yep. That did happen to me a couple times.
Alfaro throws the screen. Complete to Gahey. Gahey is stopped with a sensational tackle by LeCharles McDaniel as he went through three blockers to make the stop after a gain of 3 yards. This is a great defensive play by McDaniel. Watch this, Lee.
Let's watch the screen setup. We've talked about the acting ability, how important that is, how the quarterback has to look downfield as if he's going to throw an actual pass. There, the screen sets up very well, but as you pointed out, Ted, watch number 45 come right through the blockers and take on this. Oh, my goodness, that's an excellent play.
McDaniel is 5'10", 178 pounds. Gahey, 6'3", 220. Third down and long. Scrambles, still looking, still scrambling. Throws across field to Parmalee, intercepted. Number 20, Chris Jones at the 40-yard line. Parmalee and Edmund Alarcio have a couple of words. Parmalee thought that he was interfered with, but Chris Jones stepped in front and made the play.
If we can see the action in the secondary, we can see what Perry Parmalee perhaps was talking about. He feels that he was interfered with. Now watch a great effort by Dave Alfaro, because he's going to show a lot of poise here and get eluding a rush. He gets away from one man there. He's going to scramble out to his left, and he's going to look downfield for Parmalee. Now let's see in the secondary if we can see the interference that Parmalee thought was his. There it is right there. He was actually knocked down.
Back to live action is Jackson. Takes the ball, Jackson on his way. Jackson at the 5-yard line. Jackson finally went out of bounds at the 4 by Schatzman and Harrison. Lewis Jackson, number 9, a 30-yard gain for Jackson, and he came very close to scoring on that one.
Very reminiscent of a play we saw last week when we looked at the film yesterday of the ball game against Jacksonville State, where he took the power pitch around the right side, hurdled the line of scrimmage, and went about that same distance for a touchdown. That time it was the power pitch to the left, and you saw some of that open field ability and also the speed of Lewis Jackson.
First and goal from the 9-yard line as Jackson has now carried 13 times for 82 yards, and he's doing with a badly bruised shoulder. David Trathen. Trathen in at fullback picks up a yard. Number 80, Dave Stonak makes the stop. Trathen, just a freshman out of Sacramento, 6'1", 210-pounder, only 18 years old.
You see Craig Johnson from time to time stepping back from that huddle. What he's doing is looking to the sideline where the plays are flashed to him by the offensive coordinator.
Whistles blowing all over. An official's timeout. Okay. As you take a look at the official, let us remind you about ABC's Monday Night Football. Big game, an Eastern Division American Conference game between the New England Patriots and the Miami Dolphins. Don't miss Frank Gifford, Howard Cosell, and Dandy Don Meredith. NFL Monday Night Football coming up this coming Monday night. It's a big game for the New England Patriots.
Is it Dandy or Fran this year? How do we know for sure? We'll find out.
The give is to Jackson. Jackson cuts up field, gets to the 5-yard line, down to the 4. Dave Ramona makes the stop. Three minutes, 34 seconds left to play in the first half. Cal Poly out on top, 14-7, and a chance to make it more here. Third down and goal from the 5-yard line.
See if Craig Johnson comes with his favorite play, which is the sprint out to the wide side of the field, which in this case would be the right, and where they flood that zone again.
Johnson has carried the ball 14 times this year. He doesn't really like to run with it. Johnson gives to his fullback, Trathen. Trathen stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Number 63, Garfield Scott, the man waving his arm in the air after making the stop. They give him no gain on the play. It'll be fourth down and a field goal kicking situation. Number 21, Tom Vasella, who's already... Oh, Santa Clara finds themselves down by 10 here with 2 minutes and 20 seconds left to play here in the first half. They were down last week, Lee, and came back to beat a Northern Michigan team that was ranked number 2 in the country.
Dave Alfaro was sensational in that ball game. He threw 3 touchdown passes and for over 300 yards.
355 yards and 3 touchdowns last week.
Yep.
Check at 321 yards last week. The kickoff going to Forte in the end zone. One-handed grab. And it won't go from there.
Pretty casual, wasn't it?
Very cavalier attitude toward that.
Forte,
yes.
Not to be confused with 40.
A 39-yard drive in 5 plays after the interception by Chris Jones. Give 3 points to the Mustangs from Cal Poly.
Hurry up offense about due now for Santa Clara. 2:27 remaining. Let's see if they do anything different with their passing game. They may want to utilize the sideline a little more.
There's Dave Alfaro. They give up the middle to Gahey and didn't fool anybody that time. Fred Rezzo makes the stop along with Hugh Dugan. 2-yard gain. Check a 2-yard loss that they give him on the forward progress. Alfaro back to pass again. Across the middle, complete to Page. Page breaks one tackle but can't get away from the second as he's down at the 30-yard line. Kaufman and Kirchhoff, the men making the stop. Page loses his helmet. Clock continues to run with 1:57. Reminder, we'll have the Fireman Fun flashback for you as you take a look at this play again.
Once again, straight dropback passing by Alfaro, and Page really runs an excellent route here, and he catches the ball in a lot of traffic, and I don't think he's too excited about coming over the middle with some of the hits that have been going on with this. He does it again.
Page again at the 50-yard line and down at the 46. Number 58, Ben Hasselberg finally gets him down. And with double coverage on Parmalee, Page is having a field day. 23-yard pass completion. Kirk Fletcher replaces Perry Parmalee in the lineup. Parmalee was injured on the last play. There's Greg Page. Pass goes incomplete to Page and out of bounds. Page has now made 4 catches for 54 yards in the ballgame. That stops the clock with 1:32. Let me talk to you again as we see a flag down on the far side of the field about that Fireman's Fun flashback at halftime. We'll take a look at some of the great quarterbacks around the country this year. And Lee, a former great quarterback himself, there have been some excellent ones.
Well, I got to see Jim McMahon twice. He's the man who led the nation in passing efficiency, and he was sensational. Of course, the all-time leading passer in Division I-AA, Neil Lomax of Portland State.
And Bo.
Let's listen.
Personal foul. That's 2 personal fouls against Santa Clara. Interestingly enough, the last time these two teams met, there were 5 personal fouls called, and they were all against Cal Poly. You don't want to go anywhere, do you, Lee? It's right behind you.
Not for a while, although I'm going to be leaving
on
you shortly because I'm going to go down the field
second
and talk to the coaches at halftime. So if you don't hear me, you'll know. I'm gone.
Boy, that really stalls the drive. They were clear up to the 44-yard line. Now Alfaro has very long yardage. Alfaro's got plenty of time. Now being chased. Still has plenty of time. Throws across the middle to Page again. And Page is down at the 46-yard line. Edmund Alarcio makes the stop. Well, that's got the 15 yards back. 1:11 left to play here in the first half.
Looked like we saw a flag, but actually they were just marking the spot. Now you're going to see, again, some of the scrambling ability of Alfaro. I didn't realize he was this good of a scrambler, but he has shown us a lot today in this type of a situation where he moves around. Reminds me a little bit of John Elway of Stanford. We were talking about quarterbacks a moment ago. Now he really takes his time, looks downfield. finds the open target. Apparently, there's the aforementioned.
You did see a flag.
Yeah.
It's interesting. And then they pulled it back. Santa Clara has called timeout with 59 seconds left to play. Page has now caught five passes for 69 yards. Tomorrow, don't miss College Football 80. Check the listings in your area. You'll see some of the great games, Florida State versus Florida, Florida against Florida State, and Notre Dame versus USC, one of the great classic games of all time on College Football 80 tomorrow. Check the local listings in your area over most of these ABC stations. A reminder, next Saturday, you're going to see the NCAA Division II championships. There's timeout here with the 59 seconds left to play. The Division II championships and the Division I AA semifinal games, Eastern Kentucky versus Lehigh and Grambling versus Boise State. But the winner of this game, and Cal Poly is leading it right now, in the championship game, the Zia Bowl, as you take a look at Pat Malley. And there's Joe Harper up in the upper left-hand part of your screen. NCAA College Football next Saturday right here on ABC. First and 10, or check down. It is second and 10. Flag goes down on Farrell across the middle. Complete to his tight end, Otterson. Another flag is down. Stop made by Ralph Gallagher. There's one flag down right at the start of the play. And there's another flag back down in the defensive backfield. Parmalee got a good hit. This may be offensive offsetting penalties with 52 seconds left to play here in the first half. Lee Grosskopf down on the field. He'll be talking to Joe Harper, the Cal Poly coach, the leading coach, as he goes into halftime.
Come on, Ralph. Go.
Let's see what the call is. 17-7 our score here. Cal Poly out on top by 10 points. Okay, we've got illegal motion. Both against Santa Clara. Illegal block is the second call. The illegal block against Santa Clara. And the illegal motion call against Santa Clara. Okay, let's watch it again and see if you can find out where the illegal motion was. So far, no illegal motion. There it is. Gahee got a little early jump. Now, Alfaro straight back to pass. Throwing across the middle. Complete to Otterson. Now, Parmalee's going to come in from your left side, and the call is against Parmalee. I don't think you're going to be able to see it. Good hit that time by number 26, Ralph Gallagher. That's Otterson.
We've got motion, offense, right here, defense, cancel out. We're going to replay, third down.
Okay, now they do call it against the defense. The original call was an illegal block against the offense. And they came back to change it. We're going to play it again. Alfaro is now 9 for 16, 97 yards, and one interception. Dave Alfaro. Third down and 15. Big blitz on. The pass to Gahee. And a good stop by Jan Kirchhoff. Actually lost a yard on the play. 39 seconds. Clock ticking away. And Santa Clara will now let it all go out before they kick off. Watch it here. Good blitz this time by number 56, Mel Kaufman. Kaufman just about gets him. Now he barely gets it off to Gahee. And Kirchhoff with a great hit. Kirchhoff has 93 tackles on the year. It's fourth down, 12 yards to go. A punting situation for number two, Brian Sullivan. And now, they've taken too much time, which is exactly what Santa Clara wanted to do. The clock has stopped with 11 seconds left to play. 17-7, our score here as we get set for halftime. Great halftime show for you. Fireman Fun Flashback and the Cal Poly Marching Band. There's Robbie Martin. Bill Johnson is the man who heads up the Cal Poly Marching Band. I'll tell you, he really has that game going. Too much time by Santa Clara. Five penalties, 57 yards against Santa Clara so far. As you take a look at the speedster, Robbie Martin. 41 yards. He's going to take it himself. And it's going to go nowhere with it. Look at it. Sullivan is down at the 34-yard line. I got to talk to Lee Grosskopf about that at halftime. But that is going to end the half with what he did. He let the clock run out. It's a good thing he let the clock run out because Cal Poly would have been in field goal range. Lee Grosskopf is down on the field with Pat Smalley, the head coach of Santa Clara. Lee Grosskopf down on the field. Lee and Pat now.
Coach, you're down 17-7. Now, what adjustments do you think you're going to have to make in this second half?
Well, I think the biggest adjustment that we're going to have to make, Lee, is we're going to have to stop making some of the mistakes that are self-destructing us. You know, the penalties, the fumbles, the pass interception, and those are the things that really held us back. And we're just going to have to eliminate those in the second half and play better than we did in the first half. It's as simple as that. There's no big secret to it.
They seem to be dominating as far as the rushing game is concerned. What are you going to do to shut that down?
Well, we'll probably try and change up a little bit more and get out of we've been running the same defense maybe two times in a row. We're going to have to change that up, and we're going to have to start coming with the linebackers a little bit. We didn't do that enough in the first half, and I think we'll probably do that in the second half.
Coach, thanks a lot. Good luck to you.
Ted? Lee Grosskopf down on the field with Pat Malley. Thank you, Lee. We'll be back with today's halftime activities after this message about an upcoming show on ABC. And I might add, a word from our local station. Unfortunately, Lee Grosskopf was down to talk with Joe Harper, the head coach at Cal Poly. But Cal Poly wants to play football, so Lee is headed back up to the booth. We won't be able to talk to Joe Harper here at halftime. I got a feeling Joe's not going to give us a... I got to believe that Joe is not going to give us a whole lot of information of what he's going to do in the second half. When you lead by 10 points, you want to protect that. Plus the fact, you know, on a college game, you don't want to intrude what they're here to do, and they're here to play football. That's what we got for you here in the second half. You can expect a lot of throwing from Santa Clara and some excellent offense and defense. We've seen some super defense from Cal Poly so far. We told you about those great Cal... We'll be taking a look at the Cal Poly defensive players right after this kickoff. Vasella, Tom Vasella sets the kickoff. That's Forte back deep for Santa Clara. Vasella's kick coming to 40 at the 6-yard line. 15, 20, 25. Still on his feet and finally wrestled down at the 27-yard line. Let's take a look at those linebackers. Sven Hasselberg out of Cupertino, 6'1", 210. Kirchhoff, 93 individual tackles from Santa Maria. And Mel Kaufman, 6'3", 210-pounder. Three excellent, excellent linebackers. As Dave Alfaro comes onto the field. 26-yard return for Forte, Tyrone Forte. And he stays in the backfield in the I formation with Tony... This is fullback. Alfaro gives to Gahey a big gaping hole in the line as he carries up to the 38-yard line. Then Hasselberg makes the stop. Tom Gilmartin, 6'6", 250-pound sophomore. Hugh Duggan, 6'2", 220-pound senior. Kevin Reeder, 6'2", 225-pound senior. And Jerry Schmidt, that's the defensive line for Cal Poly. And this is Tom Perry, a fellow you'll see a lot, number 92. And Fred Rezzo, number 99. Rezzo's a junior, and Perry is a senior. Alfaro on second and three. Give to Forte. Flag down at the line of scrimmage. Forte breaks the tackle at the line. Takes it across the 45-yard line before Gilmartin and Hasselberg make the stop. But the head linesman, Tom Ellers, threw a flag just as the play started.
Probably illegal motion. Hey, it's nice to be back upstairs with you.
You did a super job down there. How was it down the field, sir? Cole, wind factor? Ralph Gallagher, the cornerback for Cal Poly. Chris Jones, the fellow that made the interception. Edmund Alarcio, the headache kid. And Charles McDaniels out of Salinas.
They marked off five against Santa Clara.
Offside, offense, second down.
They lined up offside.
I thought so.
Greg Page into the Santa Clara lineup. Page splits wide to the left. Parmalee comes to the right. Shadow starting across the field. Straight back. For Gahee, in and out of his hands. Gahee had it at the 50-yard line, but couldn't hold on. Tony Gahee, the former tight end. There you see again the backfield and receivers, the offensive team for Santa Clara. Dave Alfaro, Tony Gahee, the man who just missed the pass. Tylan Forte, he'll alternate in there with Jim Lane and the offensive line. Big 235 to 240 across the front line. Alfaro now 10 for 18 for 95 yards. Alfaro the pass again. Goes across the middle. Complete to number 84, Kirk Fletcher, and Fletcher takes it all the way down to the 22-yard line before Ralph Gower finally hauls him in. 35-yard gain for Kirk Fletcher. We have 227 yards coming into this game. And takes a rest.
That was really an outstanding crossing pattern that time by Kirk Fletcher, and I don't know what happened in the coverage because he was wide open.
Absolutely right.
Obviously, some type of breakdown in the Cal Poly secondary because you rarely see a man that wide open on a crossing pattern.
Come on, oh! This is the drive Santa Clara needed. Alfaro gives to Forte. Forte breaks across the middle for a couple of yards. Tom Gilmartin and Sven Hasselberg with the stop. 3-yard gain for Forte. Tyrone Forte, just a sophomore out of Mount Thuring. Mentioned earlier, his brother Troy plays here. Had to sit out this year with an injury.
Gilmartin has really made a difference for the Cal Poly defense. Really impressive in the ballgame last week against Jacksonville State.
Only 10 tackles and 3 sacks.
3 sacks, 10 tackles. Not too shabby.
Offensive guard last year, as a matter of fact. Second down and 7. The gift to Gahee as he finds a hole down to the 25-yard line. Jan Kirchhoff and Sven Hasselberg after a 5-yard gain.
That play has been very effective for them today. It's a fake pitch trap. I don't know if you notice, he spins, fakes the pitch out, and then slips the ball to the fullback who's following in behind a pulling guard on the trap play. 7 rushes, 37 yards.
Third down and still about 3 yards to go. Jones picks up his second interception. The score stays at 17-7. 12:14 left in the third quarter. We'll be back.
You know, I love the fresh, clean smell of barley because I can almost taste the Schlitz beer I'm going to make from it. I'm Frank Selinger. Recently, I came to Schlitz as chief executive. Mostly, I check on the business end. But after 40 years as a master brewer, I check the barley, too, and the other fine grains to make a really smooth beer. Taste my Schlitz.
As I've been saying, that's only my broker's opinion. What does your broker think?
My broker's E.F. Hutton. Mm-hmm. And E.F. Hutton says...
When E.F. Hutton talks, people listen.
The West Coast Athletic Conference is currently in its 28th year of operation as one of the country's finest basketball conferences, with Santa Clara and St. Mary's also participating in football. Conference members include 8 schools, which are covered by virtually every major media market on the West Coast.
With the score 17-7, Lee, let's take a look at the third Santa Clara turnover.
Important one it was, because the Broncos were moving, and what you're going to see here is that Alfaro throws the ball into coverage. We've got a safety zone back here, and Parmalee appears to be open momentarily, but as he cuts back in, Chris Jones, number 20, the free safety, steps in front and picks off the football.
He picked it off at the one-yard line, and Craig picks up 1 yard on the first down. Mark McAtee makes the stop along with Garfield Scott.
I didn't get a chance to talk to Joe Harper at halftime, as you know, Ted, but what I wanted to ask him was, what do you do when you're ahead 17-7? Do you sit on this lead, do you play it cozy, or do you continue with the same game plan? I don't think he can afford to get too conservative.
No, but I think they'll go a lot more running.
They like to run anyway.
Greg Johnston, the senior out of St. Paul High School in Whittier. You see how close they are to the end zone. Jackson over his right guard, picks up a couple as he crosses the 5-yard line. Tony Green, number 53, out of Vallejo, makes the stop. Green, an interesting linebacker, transferred from San Jose State and ran into his old teammate the first game of the year. 3-yard gain that time. Cal Poly lost that game. Interestingly enough, Lee, they lost by 2 touchdowns to San Jose and had 2 turnovers inside the 5-yard line. And San Jose is a team that beat Baylor, one of the top teams in the country.
But, well, that's good. That's interesting.
Craig Johnston, you see his stats so far. Third down. If Santa Clara can stop him here, they should get the ball back in good position. Jackson breaks 1 tackle, breaks 2 tackles, and gets out and grabs the first down. A sensational individual effort by Jackson. Finally, Jeff Lane and Andy Schatzman make the stop on it. A 5-yard gain on the first down. Lee, this is great individual
effort. That's exactly what it is. The individual effort by Lewis Jackson, career rushing leader. They call it 5, 7, and 9, a winning combination. We talked about it at the top of the show. Here comes Jackson. He originally was headed off tackle. He makes his move to the outside, loses 1 tackler, loses the 2nd tackler. Now watch him go for this first down yardage. He sees the stripe, and he goes for it. And he gets the valuable yardage right there.
In motion is Martin. Before Harrison makes the stop, and that's the play they ran on the first serve.
Same identical play, fake pitch trap, hand the ball to the fullback, and that time he went over the left guard, number 70, Ed Hill. He's been running a lot to his right behind number 96, Mike Dahl, who is a good one.
30 yards on that play. Mike Dahl, a senior out of Camp Lejeune, North Carolina. His little brother, 6'6 and a half, 235 pounds, Charles Dahl, also plays.
How little is little brother? That's
does a little dance, fumbles the ball, and Santa Clara says they recovered. We'll see. Rick O'Leary makes the stop, and Santa Clara does recover. Big play. You can tell who got by the 2 stands.
That is the first turnover for Cal Poly. And a big one for Santa Clara. Here's the first big break of the day for the Broncos, and a break that could make a difference. They're trailing in the game 17-7. Here's the handoff to Lewis Jackson. He starts to go wide. Now watch, first of all, Craig O'Leary, number 39, and then the loose football, and who comes up with it? Did we ever find out? Jeff Harris.
Harrison. All right, sir. Alfaro, Deporte. Deporte stopped after a gain of about 3 at the 35-yard line by Kaufman and Kirchhoff, the double K, the special K connection here at Cal Poly.
The special K connection.
Special K connection. Hey, if you can call them the Big Three from San Luis, we can.
They told me they don't like San Luis. They say it's San Luis Obispo, and don't say San Luis. All right.
Tyron Forte, number 32. Alfaro throws complete to Parmalee. Parmalee wrestled out of bounds by number 37, Sherman Turntime. Turntime, a sophomore from Walgreens.
Is that Parmalee's first catch of the afternoon? I know he's been close.
He has had a couple of receptions that have been knocked out of his hand. That is his first catch.
His first catch of the day.
Great defense.
That they felt would be one of the keys today would be shutting down Perry Parmalee, who, according to Pat Malley, is the finest receiver they've ever had at Santa Clara. Only a junior.
Third down, 2 yards to go. Gahee is close to a first down. Fred Rezo. Alonso, number 99, and Jan Kirchhoff, the middle linebacker, make the stop. I don't care how close they are. I got to believe they're going to go for it here, Lee. They might go for the field goal here. They certainly have a field goal kicker who can do it. Brian Sullivan has hit 13 of 19 field goals this year.
And he's practically perfect from this range, if I remember. This particular range right in here is his best and most consistent.
Well, Pat Malley has a decision to make down on the sideline. And he is sending in Kurt Fletcher, number 84. And Fletcher is not the field goal kicker. There's Joe Harper, the Cal Poly coach, looking on. Big defensive play here.
Dave Alfaro has called his own number in situations like this in the past. Let's see if he does it again.
I don't think he's going to do it now with Jan Kirchhoff right up there on the line of scrimmage. Takes a give, the pass. Intercepted by number 53, Kirchhoff. Look out, folks. Kirchhoff is at the 50. Kirchhoff has gone all alone and four blockers behind him. On fourth down and one, Jan Kirchhoff steps in front of the pass intended for Tony Gahee and takes it 80 yards for the score. Joe Harper looks on.
What a play, huh? That's what's called a middle linebacker's dream.
They just got a smile out of Joe Harper, I'll tell you that one. Watch it again. Number 53 is Jan Kirchhoff. He's right there in the middle.
The key really is the pressure right here. There is the pressure, and watch number 53, Jan Kirchhoff, at his middle linebacker position, and watch the host of blockers that he picks up en route to the end zone.
I could have run that one back.
Yes, you could have. Even now.
Vesela tries the extra point. It's good. 8:35 left to play here in the third quarter. Cal Poly, San Luis Obispo, taking a commanding lead, 24-7. Stay with us.
Sony introduces the art of watching.
Forte back deep. Well, that's interesting. We've got a 5-yard penalty delay of game against Cal Poly. Must have been on the extra point. No, it would have been on the extra point. Number 20 back there is Chris Jones. Check in. 20 is Joe Carey. Vesela misses the ball. It's been a while since I've seen that.
Was that a gadget play? No, that was just a miss.
The ball fell off the tee.
Boy. That last graphic we just saw, the rushing stat, is really the story of the game. Cal Poly now totally dominating. They have 166 yards rushing to 49 to Santa Clara, and they, as a result of that, they've really been able to eat up the clock.
Tyrone Forte, he could run one back, which he is definitely capable of doing. He averages 19.4 yards a kickoff return.
And he had 853 yards rushing during the year on 173 carries, so he's been hot.
Vesela will try to hit the ball this time. That'll be one of my embarrassing moments. Short kick coming to Carey. Carey at the 20, 25, 30. Fumbles the ball. Intercepted by number 40, Edmund Alarcio. And Alarcio, he is not going to be able to progress. They call it a fumble recovery. I have to question that call. If he recovers a fumble, he can't.
The ball may not be advanced in college football.
Unless they take it out of the air, which is what he did.
Which, yeah, that's what I thought, too.
Well, now Cal Poly very much taking over this game as Santa Clara giving it to them with mistakes. Edmund Alarcio takes it right out of the air, and it'll be first and 10 Cal Poly at the 37-yard line. Johnston fakes the gift to Jackson. Back to pass. Throwing into the punt from Robbie Martin. He's got it at the 14-yard line. Okay, let's watch the big play right here, and lead. Tell how important this rush is from Mel Kaufman.
Going back three plays now, the real key to this interception. Watch right linebacker Mel Kaufman, number 56, with his penetration and pressure on quarterback Dave Alfaro right about now. This is what forces the interception. He's throwing. He should have not thrown this football. He does throw it. He doesn't see the middle linebacker, Jan Kirchhoff, number 53. Kirchhoff grabs the ball, picks up his blockers into the end zone for the touchdown.
First and 10 for Cal Poly after the 12-yard gain. The pitch out to Jackson. Jackson on the sweep, trying to turn up. Flag goes down. Jackson crosses the 20 down to about the 18-yard line. Jeff Lane makes the stop, but two flags are down on the offensive backfield. Legal procedure against Cal Poly.
This is really a very important defensive series right now for the Broncos because the momentum has swung so strongly now to Cal Poly. They could put this game on ice before too much longer. 24-7, and they're threatening to go to a 31-7 lead.
We got clipping.
Clipping.
Offense. Replay. First down.
That brings the ball back to the 42-yard line. .753 left to play here in the third quarter. Johnston to Jackson. Jackson makes about 6 or 8 yards on his own as he goes right through Andy Schatzman, who was there to make the tackle, and he picks up 5 more yards before Mark McAtee makes the final stop. 10-yard gain for Jackson.
Good call. Quick screen or slip screen. That's where you get the ball out to your best back in a hurry. And he gets up two or three linemen right in front of it.
Jackson came into the game with 17 receptions for 129 yards. He's now got 18 carries for 105 yards. Third down is still about 17 yards to go. Again, they go to Jackson. Jackson is hauled down from behind at the 30-yard line by number 39, Greg O'Leary, the defensive tackle. O'Leary, who used to be a linebacker, showed excellent speed in getting over there to catch Jackson from behind.
Quick screen right, quick screen left. One of the rules that they put in 3 years ago in college football is that linemen can be downfield as long as the pass is caught behind the neutral zone. So if you see linemen downfield and the ball is caught behind the line of scrimmage or the neutral zone, it is legal.
Which opened up the passing game a lot more.
Yeah.
There's Lewis Jackson. Third down, 15 yards to go. Blitz is on. They pick it up, throwing, incomplete, intended for the tight end, Wise. Doug McCann there with the stop. McCann had the shot at the interception, number 25, the freshman out of Castro Valley, Doug McCann.
That is a timing play, and the timing was just a little bit off.
More than a little, as Brooks Wise hadn't even turned around.
Yep.
Fourth down. And a field goal try for Vasella. Johnston is 8 for 15 now for 79 yards. Johnston will hold here.
No.
47-yard attempt. Is wide to the right. I'll tell you, he's got a toe. He really... 6:04 left to play as Santa Clara stops the threat. 24-7 is our score. We'll be back. You stay with us.
That's Coach Johnson. He's from the college. Looks like he's worried about his problem dandruff. I wish he'd ask me.
Mr. Owens, I need a shampoo.
Ever try Tegrin?
Can it really work on my itching and flaking?
Well, in a national survey, 3 out of 4 dermatologists judge Tegrin's medication effective in fighting even problem dandruff.
Mm-hmm. I'll give it a tryout.
Hey, how's that dandruff problem?
Tegrin's a winner, Mr. Owens.
Prove it to yourself. Tegrin works.
This is a modern-day giant. It does the work of yesterday's room-sized computer.
Yet it's this small. A new computer on a chip from Bell Laboratories.
Technology like this helps our network make home and office communications more reliable and economical. And in the future, will help transmit information services that put data and pictures at your fingertips. The Bell System, keeping your communication system the best in the world.
Next Saturday on ABC's Wide World of Sports, championship boxing. Salvador Sanchez and Juan Laporte fight for the WBC World Featherweight title. Next Saturday on ABC.
I'm Ted Dawson along with Lee Grosskopf, and Lee has just told me this is a VID, Lee.
That's what's known as a very important drive for the Broncos because they need to put something on the board. They're down 24-7. And they have not been moving the football too effectively, and when they do move the football, it seems like they always cough it up. They've been hurt today by turnovers. One of the things that Pat Malley told me yesterday was that in addition to stopping the big play of Cal Poly, that they were going to have to be opportunistic. They were going to have to take advantage of mistakes. Well, Cal Poly hasn't made that yet.
That was Jim Lane on the last carry. Second down, still 8 yards to go. Alfaro, who's 12 for 22 with three interceptions so far this afternoon, puts Kirk Fletcher in motion. On the reverse to Fletcher. Well covered by Cal Poly. Number 99, Fred Razzo, with a flag down, comes back over to make the stop. Santa Clara with three turnovers. Cal Poly with one.
Got 75 hold.
Kevin Reeder with the hold. Shadows across the field. Lee, does that cause you problems?
It can cause problems for receivers in certain situations because the ball comes out of the sun and into the shade very suddenly, or vice versa.
Excuse me, Lee, I got to correct something. I said there was...
We got holding.
The hold. They got
offense. Second down.
Reeder is the defensive man. They got 75 against the offensive man, Chuck Buckingham, the center. There's Pat Malley. He's got a big hill to climb. And Santa Clara keeps stopping themselves. Second down and long. Alfaro downfield. Intended for number 85, his tight end Phil Otterson. Otterson had a step on number 56, Mel Kaufman, but Alfaro couldn't get the ball to him. Otterson didn't even make much of a try for it, did he?
Well, he hasn't been that much of a receiver at the tight end position. He has been primarily a blocker all season long. He didn't seem like he really knew where the football was.
Wide to the right on third down and very long yard. 27 yards to go. Far with time. Now he's tackled by number 99, Fred Razzo. Back at the 5-yard line. Razzo, the junior out of Santa Maria. And Cal Poly, Lee, has really taken over this game in the second half. 4:50 to play here in the third quarter.
Let's watch Razzo, number 99, and this is what they have done so consistently all day. And even when they haven't gotten all the way to the passer, they have penetrated well. Defensive tackle, number 99, Fred Razzo, who is a backup to Hugh Dugan, number 93, most of the time.
He ran straight through two blockers. Sullivan, back to kick from deep in his own end zone. He'll have about a yard to spare. Gets off a high kick. Robbie Martin at the 47. Martin hit at the 40 and stopped right there. Making the stop is number 61, Scott Gordon for Santa Clara, along with Joe Carey, number 20. There's a flag down back at the 5-yard line. A 40-yard kick, 5-yard return. Santa Clara with 7 penalties so far. This may be 8 here.
Turnovers and penalties thus far have killed the Broncos.
Personal foul called against Cal Poly. There's Joe Harper.
The man who, as you pointed out, has never had a losing season here at Cal Poly. This could be a break that the Broncos need.
It's not going to be enough, unless it's a roughing the kicker penalty. It wouldn't be enough for the first down. Thank you. Pat Malley, hoping it's a roughing the kicker.
We got personal foul, defense, at the snap, fourth down again.
Yeah.
Fourth down again.
Not roughing the kicker.
Personal foul at the snap.
At the snap. You see the update on the penalties is Brian Sullivan back to kick. Sullivan, good kick. Martin takes it at the 41. 50. There he goes, Robbie Martin. He's got one more man to beat. He beats him. Brian Sullivan was the last man. And Robbie Martin takes it 58 yards for the touchdown. That was a great run. He went through the six people at the 50-yard line. Six white shirts were around him, and he went right through them.
You just knew this was going to happen at some point in the football game. It's hard to contain Robbie Martin for 60 minutes.
Robbie Martin.
They have been pretty effective shutting him down as a receiver, but now he gets the ball on one of his specialties, the punt return.
Now look at the white shirts.
There are a lot of white shirts at the 50, and watch how many disappear in a hurry. There you see some of that sprinter speed.
Sullivan's got a shot.
He has a shot. He has the angle, too.
Goodbye.
Yeah, look at those feet.
He is really an exciting football player. The extra point is... Well, the official is now talking to the Santa Clara player. There's a flag down back in the end zone. Well, Lee, until we see what it is, the score is 31-7. Let's remind you about ABC's Wide World of Sports as it returns next Saturday, 5 o'clock Pacific time. Well, before that, let's remind you about Monday Night Football. It's live at 6 o'clock Pacific Standard Time. There it is, the New England Patriots against the Miami Dolphins. A big game for the New England Patriots in the American Football Conference Eastern Division game. 31-7 is the score.
I just
so
have
the kick
to say
was
this.
Good.
I just have to say this. Those are two teams that don't like each other very much.
And never have. All right, now we get the penalty called. It was called on the kick against Santa Clara, and they take it on the ensuing kickoff. 12 players on the field. 31-7 is the score. It remains the same. Well, they'll kick off from the 45. Vasella will kick off from the 45-yard line. Forte and Carrier back deep. A short kick. You're calling a fair catch. I don't know if he knows you don't fair catch on a kickoff, Lee.
No, you can.
Yeah, you can.
Yeah.
I apologize. I didn't think you could fair catch on a kickoff. Okay, I stand corrected. Number 90, Vince Canelo takes it. Okay, after that's all squared away, Santa Clara will take off from their own 19-yard line. Make it the 18-yard line. 31-7 is the score as Cal Poly has run away with it here in the second half. Tony Gahee hit by Kirchhoff at the line of scrimmage, falls forward for maybe a yard.
The Broncos now are trailing by 24 points, and what was a game plan for them initially now has changed because they're really in a posture of playing catch-up football. That means that they're going to have to start throwing the football a lot more on the early downs.
Cal Poly has scored two touchdowns in the second half on what you'd have to call fluke plays. As Alfaro rolls out the pass, throws complete to Fletcher. Fletcher run out of bounds by number 37, Sherman Turntime. 14 yards in the first down. Number 84, Kirk Fletcher, comes in for one play and then gets a rest.
Well, remember that they are the messengers. He and Greg Page run the plays in and out from the sidelines, from Pat Malley to quarterback Dave Alfaro. He, in turn, has the ability to check off if he wants to. He does occasionally, not often.
Throwing complete at the 45-yard line to his fullback, Gahee. Gene Underwood with the stop.
That was a great move that time by Dave Alfaro. As he scrambled to his left, he was throwing on the dead run to his left and wound up with a 12-yard completion to Tony Gahee, his fullback. Gahee did a good thing coming back there. You mentioned earlier that he was a tight end, so he has the instincts of a receiver, even though he is now a fullback.
Fletcher wide to the right, Connolly to the left. On the draw, they give us the lane, and going nowhere. Number 59, Steve Piscavardi.
Swarming, gang tackling by the Mustangs, and they have been doing that all afternoon. When I was standing down there on the field, I got a sense of some of the contact, and they really hit. They will hit you.
Piscavardi with a 4-yard loss. Makes it second down, 14 yards to go. Pat Malley has got to be wondering about his bag of tricks. Page in motion, fake the give to Lane. Alfaro looking to throw long. Almost intercepted. Number 37, Sherman Turntine, had his shot. And you got to say, Alfaro's not having one of his best days as the passer's intended for Page.
Well, we'll look at his stats in a minute. He's not having a good day, but a lot of it, not all of it is his fault. He's been on target several times. Passes have been dropped. He has been throwing under pressure all afternoon. He's 14 of 26 in the passing department. Three interceptions. 161 yards. He did get the game's only touchdown on a quarterback sneak. For them, game's only touchdown for Santa Clara.
Third down, 14 yards to go. As you see Pat Malley up in the upper left-hand part of your screen. Alfaro under pressure, throws incomplete, intended for Otterson, number 85. That was thrown a little too hard as Jan Kirchhoff was there on the defense.
However, that's exactly what I was saying. That was a catchable ball. He's thrown a number of catchable balls, and he's been throwing under a lot of pressure all afternoon. I'm very sympathetic to quarterbacks, as you can tell.
As you always have been.
Yes.
Dave Alfaro, an academic All-American, a dental student at Santa Clara, as Brian Sullivan goes back in punt formation. Robbie Martin standing back at his 13-yard line. Sullivan gets the good snap, kicks it way away from Martin, as I would too. Goes out of bounds near the 15-yard line. There's 1:47 left to play here in the third quarter. 31-7 is our score. Back right after this message from the NCAA.
In 1980, ABC Sports was proud to bring you the most unforgettable moments in sports. The magic and the miracles. Impossible dreams come true. In 1981, there will be more miracles, unexpected victories, and unbelievable defeats. Unknown athletes in pursuit of glory. Unforgettable moments in the making. The challenge of the 80s is excellence, and you'll find it on ABC Sports, the leader in sports television.
USC. 31-7 our score here. Cal Poly with a commanding lead over Santa Clara as they've blown it open here in the second half with 1:47 left to play in the third quarter. This third quarter seems like it's taken forever, Lee.
This has been a long third quarter. There was that round of applause. USC beating Notre Dame apparently now 20-3. Is that in the third quarter?
I think it's over.
Over.
That's the big story of the game. Well, that's the big story as far as Santa Clara is concerned. Cal Poly has not done much passing, but they've done a lot of scoring. Johnson to Jackson, and Jackson hitting his own backfield, fumbles the ball. Do they say he was down? Doug McCann, the man making the stop. A of 2 yards. The official says he was down, and Lee, I got to believe it was a good call.
You know, that last graphic we looked at is a little bit misleading because the passing stats have favored Santa Clara. As we look at Lewis Jackson once again on one of his favorite plays, the blaster isolation play off left tackle, I agree with you that it was a good call. I think he was down, and then as he was spinning around, right, he lost the football.
To Spiker. Spiker turns up the field but doesn't get much before Duck McCann, number 25, makes the stop again. McCann, a freshman out of Castro Valley.
To get back to what we were talking about, so often superior passing stats belong to the losing team. In fact, many times passing records are set when a team is losing big because the quarterback has to pass a lot. So that stat actually is very misleading because you would think that Santa Clara would be better than they are based on the fact that they have so dominated in the passing department.
The turnovers have been so important. In
penalties?
Penalties and letting Robbie Martin run that kick to that punt back. Johnson under pressure, throwing complete, and out of bounds is number 83, Rick Jones. Now, Jones is a fellow we told you earlier who wears two numbers. He's also the starting right tackle, and he wears number 79 when he's the starting right tackle.
He wears number 79, and he blocks a lot with Mike Dom, and then he switches to tight end and becomes number 83. Let's look at this young man who says that he has styled himself after Pat Hayden. He's 5'10", 175 pounds, Craig Johnson, and I think he is a really superior passer. I like the way this young man throws the football. And there is indeed the aforementioned number 83, Rick Jones.
Jones out of Paramount, 6'4", 225-pound junior, 21 years old, two-year letterman here at Cal Poly.
You know where Paramount is?
Yes, I think they do. Guys. Timeout called by Cal Poly. 47 seconds left to play here in the third quarter. Reminder, next Saturday, a World Featherweight Championship fight on ABC's Wide World of Sports from El Paso, Texas. Salvador Sanchez against Juan Laporte. Sanchez, the World WBC Featherweight Champion, is his fourth title defense, a record 46 wins, one loss, and one draw, 28 knockouts. Also next Saturday, NCAA College Football, the Division II Championship, featuring the winner of this game, Cal Poly or Santa Clara, and the Division I-A semifinal games, Eastern Kentucky versus Lehigh, and Grambling versus Boise State. And I'll tell you, Lee, that should be a good ball game. I did a Grambling game earlier this year. Boise State is always an excellent football team. Cal Poly, however, beat Boise State earlier this year.
They did.
Grambling has an excellent football game, and a fellow you'll see by the name of Trumaine Johnson, who down in Grambling, they say, is the best wide receiver they've ever had. And this is a team that's produced Mike White, or Sammy White, rather,
Sammy White,
out of Minnesota. Next Saturday, here on ABC. Johnston with the pitch to Spiker. Spiker breaks a tackle and is knocked down at the 40-yard line after a gain of about 6 yards. Mark McAtee making the stop. 7-yard gain.
Now, the real story of the game is that Cal Poly has 179 yards rushing and 32 carries to Santa Clara's 37 yards net rushing. To me, that really is more significant than that passing stat, along with
question about
the turnovers that you mentioned and the penalties that we talked about.
Second down. Yeah, they give him an 8-yard gain on forward progress, so it's second down and 2. This will be the last play of the third quarter as Dan Craig takes it down to about the 43-yard line. There goes the gun for the end of the third quarter as Larry Ariglia makes the stop. Our score remains 31 for the Cal Poly Mustangs, 7 for Santa Clara. We'll be back for the final quarter. Can they come back?
I may be the only man running a major brewery who is a master brewer. Have been for 40 years. I'm Frank Selinger, Chief Executive Officer of Schlitz. 2 years ago, when they asked me to come to Schlitz, they said, Frank, let's make the best. Here it is, Schlitz. Compare Schlitz with any other beer. This has the taste that I've been after for 40 years. I know you'll like it.
Hey! You're driving half a car! to prove Haviland Supreme gives cars engine protection up front.
I know, but...
Well, you should know. It delivered proven protection in punishing state trooper testing.
Yeah, but...
Where's the rest of my car?
Yeah.
Here it comes. To prove Texaco's Haviland Supreme delivered improved mileage, too. Upfront protection backed by improved mileage. That's Haviland Supreme.
Do me a favor.
I know. Prove how good Haviland is in the next county, huh?
All right.
War blew away his future, but courage brought Rocky Blyer fighting back. Robert Urich stars Sunday.
Quarterback Dave Alfaro has thrown three touchdown passes and a come-from-behind effort in the fourth quarter before. He'll have to do it again today. First and 10 for Cal Poly at the 43-yard line. Gilmore in motion to give us to Spiker. Spiker fumbles the ball. Three Santa Clara white shirts around it. But it looks like Dan Craig, the fullback, who was blocking on the play, came up with the ball. Good effort that time by Craig. Reminder, he's just a sophomore out of San Jose, right in the country where Santa Clara comes from. Craig Leonard last year as a freshman. Second down, 6 yards to go.
Mustangs are on the move again. They could put it in the cooler with one more touchdown.
Mike Gilmore out wide to the left side. They give us to Craig. Craig runs over people down to the 46-yard line. Andy Schatzman, whose father was a professional basketball player, by the way, makes the stop. Schatzman is an ex-linebacker. 6'2", 200-pound sophomore.
That means he's now a big cornerback.
Schatzman against San Francisco State had 10 individual tackles from his cornerback position and 2 interceptions.
Once again, the real important factor, the rushing yards, 182 for Cal Poly to 37 for Santa Clara. As a result of that, they have really been able to control the football, and in total yards, 272 to 199.
That's Spiker. Spiker hits hard at the 43-yard line. He picks up the first down. Dave Ramona makes him play.
You know, sooner or later, we're going to be choosing an offensive or rather a most valuable player for both teams, for Chevrolet as the outstanding players, and in their name, of course, $1,000 to the General Scholarship Fund. Right now, I would say that the front runners in the game are two linebackers, Jan Kirchhoff and Mike Zinda. Kirchhoff has been sensational.
Kirchhoff is a sensational linebacker. You're absolutely right. He's had 14 individual tackles so far. Back to pass is Johnston. Well, he is a cool quarterback. Complete to Wise. Brooks Wise out of bounds at the 27, make it the 26-yard line. Andy Schatzman ran him out. Not to mention, Kirchhoff had the touchdown with the interception and the touchdown run.
80-yard touchdown run. That's pretty unusual for a middle linebacker, and to have 14 tackles.
Watch Craig Johnson. You've talked earlier about how it reminds you of Pat Hayden, and he tries to copy Pat Hayden. Let's watch him here.
We felt yesterday when we talked to him that he was a poised young man, and here you see that. Well, he has a really beautiful delivery. He throws that ball with a lot of authority. He throws like a much bigger man.
Brooks Wise is only 6'3", 225, as they give us to Craig again. Craig is tackled at the line of scrimmage, fights his way forward, and the tackle of Doug McCann. for a couple of yards. Also, Tim Pastoresi on the tackle.
Brooks Wise has three catches now for 39 yards. You just mentioned how effective he has been at his tight end position.
He came into the game with only six catches all year long. Well, chalk off 15 more against Santa Clara. Santa Clara's going to look at the mistakes in this game. I tell you, not for the mistakes, Santa Clara's right in this ball game. But there have been so many of them.
Take away the turnovers.
Defense, automatic first down.
First and 10 at the 11-yard line.
That's exactly right. You take away the turnovers, the penalties, the interception, and the return.
But it's kind of hard to take those away.
Yeah. you can't do it, can you? There's no way.
We never made those at Utah, did we? Not more than two or three times a play. That's Gilmore in motion. They give us to Craig again. Craig breaks a tackle at the line of scrimmage, fights his way down to the 6-yard line, gains about five before Craig Geary makes the stop.
We made them, but they just didn't call them turnovers. So they called them fumbles and interceptions.
Look it in.
12 minutes, 18 seconds left to play. Cal Poly on the drive again as they've turned this game into a rout here in the second quarter, and Santa Clara has handed it to them by mistake. Gilmore goes wide to the left. Spiker turns up field, flags fall. Spiker falls to the 3-yard line, running over the official.
There are flags all over the place.
Robert Holliday is going to earn his paycheck today. That's the umpire that just got dumped.
Well, next week we have the Zia Bowl. Today we got the Flag Bowl.
Got
holding against Cal Poly. 13 carries, 85 yards for Craig so far.
It appears that Cal Poly is probably going to win this football game, and should that be so, that's going to be an interesting matchup when they take on Eastern Illinois next week in the Zia Bowl for the Division
II. We got holding, offense, replay the down, second down.
And, of course, we'll have that game for you right here on ABC next week as you watch it again.
Let's see if we can see the holding in the offensive line. There's the pitch back to the tailback.
Spiker,
the tailback, is trying to turn the corner. He cuts up inside, and right about here is where we see the holding.
Johnston, complete to Spiker. Spiker tries to stay in bounds, but can't quite, and he goes out of bounds at the 13-yard line. Dave Ramona running him out. Ten-yard gain. Dave Ramona is another one we'd have to consider for that.
Dave Ramona you always have to consider because there is a man who is perennially around the football.
105 tackles coming into this game.
Had 16 in the ball game last time they played Cal Poly.
The defensive most valuable
season of NCAA College Division Championships in 1963, the California College Athletic Association has earned recognition as the Conference of Champions. CCAA schools have dominated over the past 12 years, winning 54 national titles.
Ted Dawson along with Lee Grosskopf, fourth quarter here in San Luis Obispo, Cal Poly over Santa Clara. It's third down, 12 yards to go, ball at the 13-yard line. In motion. Johnson throws incomplete. Intended for Brooks Wise, his tight end. And Wise couldn't hold on as Mark McAtee made the hit.
Joe Harper, the man we talked about, has never had a losing season here. He says that self-realization is what he tries to develop in his players. He says that football gives players a chance to find out more about themselves, to develop a sense of responsibility, to realize their ultimate potential.
Well, we're going to find out about Tom Vasella right now as Vasella gets set to try a 30-yard field goal. He's made one. He's missed two so far today. Johnson to hold. Off to the left. So Vasella hasn't had one of his better days. It'll be 1st and 10 Santa Clara when we return. They'll have it 1st and 10 at their 20-yard line. Dave Alfaro will bring his team up to the line of scrimmage. They've got 80 yards to go and a long way to get back in this ball game. You see the score. We'll be back right after this.
When you see how good you can be with Minolta XG1.
Hey, you want to see some terrific pictures?
Depend on the automatic Minolta XG1 to give you clear, sharp pictures. It does the work. You take the credit.
Yeah,
I agree. Hey, you want to see some terrific pictures?
No.
That's lovely.
For a limited time, get an XG1 and get a $25 rebate from Minolta. See your dealer now for details.
Introducing the 1981 Chevy Malibu Sports Sedan. A solid, sensible car with a 6-passenger interior, impressive V6 mileage, a comfortable ride, plus a little something sensible cars are not ordinarily known for. Chevrolet introduces the Malibu Sports Sedan. A four-door with a difference. A four-door with pizzazz.
11:22 left to play. 31-7 our scores. You take a look at the two head coaches, Pat Malley and Joe Harper. 1st and 10, Santa Clara from the 20. They give us to Lane. Lane on the draw, fights his way to the 24-yard line. Jerry Schmidt, number 86, makes the stop.
Year in Santa Clara told me yesterday his coaching philosophy was shaped mostly by his father, a former coach at the University of San Francisco, also by Len Casanova, and was also has been influenced by a lot of the pro teams, particularly the Cleveland Browns.
Alfaro to Fletcher. Fletcher tries to one-hand it and can't do it. You know, a lot of people forget that Santa Clara at one time had one of the top college football programs in the country. They played in the Orange Bowl back in 1950.
Exactly. The 49 season and the 50 Orange Bowl against Bear Bryant's Kentucky team, they won that game. And Malley was a player in that for that Santa Clara team. Santa Clara dropped football in 1952. Then in 1959, this man came back as the head coach, and he's been there ever since.
Dave Alfaro, who is 14 for 28 for 162 yards, comes up to the line of scrimmage. Rolling out to his right, gets an excellent block. Sets, throws across the field, incomplete, nobody there, a flag is down, back at the 25-yard line. Pass was intended for Phil Otterson, number 85.
One of the things Pat Malley told me yesterday is that they would have to run better. They would have to stop the big play, and they would have to be more opportunistic. All of those dreams have not come true today.
They have made some very serious mistakes. As you take a look at Pat Malley's
we got defense
at Santa Clara. Penalty's going to be called against Cal Poly. 10.5 minutes left. 31-7 our score. That's Joe Harper.
Here's a man with a diversified coaching background. He's essentially conservative, but it's, from time to time, you'll see him do some...
We've got face mask, defense, first down.
That's pretty clear. Face mask, defense, first down.
1st and 10, Santa Clara, 39-yard line. For Parmalee, he's got him at the 48 to the 50. Fumbles, intercepted by Kirchhoff. Ticket. That is Sikowski, 63, not 53. Let's watch it again, Lee. Parmalee has really been pummeled this afternoon.
This has been a nightmare day for a great wide receiver, number 81, Perry Parmalee. Almost every time he has had his hands on the football, he has coughed it up in one manner or another. This time he makes the catch, and after he gets hit right there, what a collision.
Dale Barthel
leveled Perry Parmalee, which cut him loose from the football.
We go back to live action. That is number 30, Jim Colvin, takes it for Cal Poly. Colvin picks up 10 yards down to the 45-yard line.
Colvin isn't even on the two deeps, is he?
No, not on the two deep.
Yep. We're getting to the three deeps now.
The two deep, of course, is the depth chart. The first team is obviously the one. The second deep that makes the two deep is the second string. New quarterback in now, too, for Cal Poly. Number 10 is the sophomore Lloyd Nelson out of San Bernardino. David Traffin with the ball that time, picks up the first down.
Lloyd Nelson is a good athlete. In fact, they've used him at halfback from time to time where he runs the option.
Nelson comes into the ball game, 5 for 14, passing for 71 yards. He's thrown two interceptions. Nelson gives to Colvin. Colvin over his left tackle, fights his way forward for about 4 yards. Number 23, Chris Lundy on the stop.
At this point, it really doesn't matter who the Mustangs have in there. They have taken control of this football game, 31-7, with less than 10 minutes remaining now. This game is winding down, and it appears that the Mustangs are headed for the Zia Bowl, and they will be playing Eastern Illinois, a big winner today over Northern Alabama.
Gives up the middle to Traffin. David Traffin picks up about 5 more yards before Dave Ramona makes the stop. Santa Clara that had that great win, that come-from-behind win over Northern Michigan. They scored with, 2 minutes left. Jim Lane took it over to win that game for him over second-ranked Northern Michigan.
Dave Alfaro was, of course, sensational in that ballgame, throwing for 3 touchdowns and over 300 yards. He has not had that kind of a day today, but it has not been all his fault.
Nelson takes it himself down to the 23-yard line. Dave Ramona and Doug McCann make the stop. 9-yard gain for Lloyd Nelson.
Rather than berate Santa Clara, I think we should talk about the fact that this has been a sensational team effort by Cal Poly. We have talked about some of the individual performers, but it has really been a collective effort today.
And this has been a team that's improved themselves throughout the year. They started, they were ranked as low as 10.
Yep.
They come in today ranked 4. Nelson takes the give again, looking to throw. Passes. Was it complete to Letterman? No, Letterman. Just a sophomore, 6'4", 185 pounds.
Hey, Nelson really zips this football. Take a look. He's an outstanding athlete. We talked about that. We haven't seen him throw yet. It's bootleg action to his left. Now watch. He's throwing on his dead run to his left. And Noel Letterman, number 85, runs a sideline cut, does a juggling act, and hangs on to the football.
Nelson to throw again. Complete. Tom Vasella to try the extra point.
Hey, world, who do you take traveling?
MasterCard!
And me. Who do you take shopping?
MasterCard. And me.
Who do you take to dinner?
MasterCard. And me.
And me.
MasterCard. And me. We can do it all.
MasterCard's the only credit card I really need. Anywhere.
MasterCard. And me. And me. We can do it all.
JCPenney's incredible
SCS Series 35-watt receiver, three-way bass reflex speakers, and belt drive turntable. One sound will tell you all you need to know about their specs. One look will show you what a great buy they are at $729.80. But look again. Right now, these incredible components are on sale for an unbelievable $499. J.C. Penney's MCS Series 35-watt system sale. The value is crystal clear.
Rick Brenneman, number 94, set to kick off for Cal Poly. Norton carry back deep. Low kick at the 20-yard line. To the 30 and run out of bounds is number 86, Tim Brigman, tight end, a freshman out of Salinas. What Cal Poly feeling their oats now, Ali? They have looked super.
Albuquerque, here we come. 38-7 with 8:05 remaining.
A lot of big things happening in this town. Their high school team is playing for the state championship next weekend, or the CIF championship.
San Luis Obispo is a beautiful place to be.
Absolutely beautiful. I wish you all could join us here this afternoon, because this is a gorgeous city. Dave Alfaro stays in. This will be his last game in a Santa Clara uniform. Tony Gahee. Gahee takes it out across the 45 to the 48-yard line before Tom Sikowski and Dale Barker make the stop. 16-yard gain for Tony Gahee out of Loyola High School in Los Angeles. That was the last drive, and done mostly by underclassmen.
By a backup quarterback, number 10, Lloyd Nelson, who took over, and he showed us something.
He did. Now, far, plenty of time. Running complete to Gahee. Across the 45, still fighting. Good job down to the 40-yard line. Barthel and Turntine with the stop. 7.5 minutes left, 12-yard gain. Tony Gahee, a big, strong junior, will be back next year.
Gahee is a superior athlete, isn't he?
Yes. Alfaro sends Fletcher out to the right side. The shadows have crossed the entire field now. Gahee gets another call. And takes it down to the 36-yard line before Steve Booker, number 55, makes the stop. Booker, just a sophomore out of La Palma. He and Hugh Dugan team up there. Dugan out of Los Alamitos. Interesting story about Dugan, who's a 6'2", 220-pound senior. Used to work with the Rolling Stones rock group, handling their music backstage.
That's quite a transition, isn't it?
Of course, he could certainly keep the teeny boppers off, that's for sure.
Sometimes that's
that was the problem we used to have with you at Utah. Keeping the groupies away from you.
The older you get, the greater you were.
Alfaro throws the screen right into traffic. Downed immediately by Steve Booker is Gahee.
A whole lot Dave Alfaro can really do with this type of a situation. He's down 38-7. 6-13. The clock is winding down. All he can do is throw the ball and hope to put a couple more up on the board. Make it look better.
Straight back. Out of the pocket. Across the field, batted down by number 60, Tom Gilmartin. Come on, Joe, smile. There's Gil Martin.
There's a man with a lot of enthusiasm. Let's watch this big number 60, Tom Gil Martin, because he has made a difference for the Cal Poly defense. He's closing in right about here, and about the time Alfaro starts to throw the football, those big hands come up. He's 6'6", 250 pounds, and he's only a sophomore.
Out of La Mirada. Carmichael splits out wide to the left side. He's a sophomore. Alfaro breaks out of the pocket, breaks a tackle, gets a big hit at the 29-yard line. Booker was there. Also, number 12, Gene Underwood. I'll tell you, Alfaro, who wants to be a dentist,
I was going to say,
may have a need of a dentist right there.
You must be reading my mind. I was thinking the same thing. He's a pre-dental student, right?
And a straight A student.
And a good one. And he may have to fix his own teeth right about now.
He really took a shot.
He's what you call a fine student athlete.
An academic All-American, Dave Alfaro, says, Coach, I want to stay in. Alfaro, who's completed 17 out of 32 passes for 186 yards, is helped off the field, I'll tell you. He is real groggy.
He ought to learn that Fran Tarkington hook slide.
Dave Alfaro gets a big hand from the stands here.
That hurts.
Cool.
He got sandwiched.
We're now going to see a fellow you know real well, Lee. His name is Mike Heinrich. He's a junior out of Saratoga. His father once played with Lee Grosskopf with the New York Giants.
Also once coached me with the New York Giants. And, of course, he's been a colleague of ours in the broadcasting industry, a color commentator.
We're talking, of course, about Don Heinrich.
Don Heinrich, who has another son, Kyle Heinrich, who I covered at the University of Washington.
Played in the Rose Bowl.
Yep.
Helped beat Michigan. Heinrich is number 17. Splits his back. And down he goes. An inauspicious beginning for Mike Heinrich.
All I can say, having had that happen to me before, is that it's embarrassing.
It is a bad part of the field.
That's right.
That's right.
He slipped.
Good news about Dave Alfaro. He was badly shaken up. He's down talking to the coaching staff on the sidelines right now. He is not injured. He was just shaken up. And is now begging the coaches right below us to go back in.
Getting back to Don Heinrich, he twice led the nation when he was at the University of Washington. Of course, he had a pretty good fella to mess around with in the back. That was Hugh McElhaney.
Hugh McElhaney, yeah. Right. The give on the draw is to Lane. Kevin Reeder, number 75, with the stop. Down on the sidelines, right now, Dave Alfaro is begging his coach, Pat Malley, to put him back in. Now the doctor is taking a look at him, pointing at his eyes. There he is. What do you see, Dave? I'm fine. Come on, coach, put me in. I'm fine. Put me in. This is my last game. There's 4:04 left to play here in this ball game. Dave Alfaro's okay. You see the score. We'll be back right after this.
Michelob brings you the 7-day weekend, all America style. Americans love weekends, not just the Saturday and Sunday kind, but whenever we take time to enjoy the good things in life, like the smooth and mellow taste of Michelob. Because all over America, Michelob helps make any time feel a little like a weekend.
Hey, put a little weekend in your week.
Yeah.
Next Saturday on ABC's Wide World of Sports, Championship Boxing. Salvador Sanchez and Juan Laporte fight for the WBC World Featherweight title. Next Saturday on ABC.
There's 4:04 left to play here, 38-7. Lee, we're going to have to pick our Chevrolet players of the game for both Santa Clara and Cal Poly. We'll give them to you here in just a second or two. Dave Alfaro is back in the game. He's number 10. Alfaro throws across the middle, complete to Fletcher. Did he fumble that?
He did. He did fumble it.
But are they going to call it a fumble? I don't think they're going to call it a fumble. Turntine, the man that came up with the ball.
I think they're going to say the fumble happened after the whistle.
Yeah.
That means the ball will be ruled dead right there at that particular point, which is about the 16-yard line.
I thought that's what the call was going to be after the
Here's the good news.
Game.
Alfaro is healthy again. He's standing tall in the pocket, and he's throwing the ball over the middle. Right there to number 84, Fletcher. Who is Kurt Fletcher, the flanker back. And you see, well, I don't know about that one.
He left it there, didn't he?
Yeah. Deposited something there that looked like a football.
Alfaro from the 13. The give is to Gahey. Gahey fights his way to the 10-yard line. Stop made by Steve Booker. Also Gene Underwood, number 12 on the stop. And number 92, Tom Perry was there. So it'll be second down and about 2 yards to go at the 9-yard line. Fletcher brings the play in from the sidelines. 3:07 left to play. Dave Alfaro, who hasn't scored since the first quarter, looks, throws, complete to Fletcher. Fletcher at the 3 and down there. Fletcher actually had a chance of picking up another yard or two if he'd gone out of bounds, but thought maybe if he stayed in bounds, he could get the score.
Well, he's going for it. Doesn't have anything to lose.
Absolutely.
38-7. What do? So try to get one more on the board.
You keep going for it.
Yeah. Looks better.
Number 90, Vince Canello checks into the lineup at tight end. First and goal from the 4. Alfaro to Lane. Lane fights his way forward. Touchdown. Lane was tackled back at the 2-yard line, but just kept pumping his leg. Got a helpful block and pushed his way over. 2:27 left to play, and Jim Lane with the score.
Let's watch number 21, Jim Lane, from his tailback position. Here is a super second and third effort, and watch him reach and stretch for the goal line right there. A man you pointed out who came on so strong in the latter part of the season.
Actually, you got to give a lot of credit to Cal Poly's number 59, Steve Pescavardi, who came in and made the hit and actually pushed him over
pushed
the goal
him
line.
The end zone,
Brian Sullivan. The kick is good. So with 2:27 left to play in the ball game, Santa Clara has scored again. The score, 38-14. We'll be back.
My alternator light won't go out.
Uh-oh.
What do you think it is, Mr. Goodwrench?
Well, let's take a look.
Mr. Goodwrench has the right GM equipment available to work on your General Motors car. Thousands of dollars worth. But he also knows the value of a well-placed thumb.
What's the problem?
Just a stretch belt. I can replace it while you wait.
All right!
That's great. GM
Beauty.
Where Mr. Goodwrench works.
With genuine GM parts.
You see the score as Sullivan sets the kickoff. Nelson, the second-string quarterback, is back deep in single safety. Everybody thought of an onside kick. Nelson takes the 15 to the 20 and down at the 21-yard line. Our Chevrolet player of the game for Santa Clara, Lee.
Well, it's kind of a tough choice, but I would say that Mike Zinda deserves the honor. He's made a total of 9 tackles, and he's one of the best freshmen they've ever had at the school.
And for Cal Poly, there he is, number 53, Jan Kirchhoff. Is he a sensational football player? There's 52, Mike Zinda, coming off the field. Kirchhoff, number 53, has 14 individual tackles, not to mention the touchdown run with the interception as Nelson rolls out the pass, takes it himself, across the 20, across the 25, still going. Nelson still on his feet. feet. He doesn't want to go down. Nelson, the 45, and finally at the 46-yard line. What a job by Lloyd Nelson. Andy Schatzman, finally. Jan Kirchhoff, our Chevrolet player of the game for Cal Poly. This is the play that turned the game around, Lee.
Actually, this is the one that pretty much put it in the cooler. Kaufman is the one who applies the pressure first. Now watch number 53, Jan Kirchhoff, the middle linebacker, step right into your picture. Alfaro never saw him, and he gets a lot of company en route to the end zone, so he has 14 tackles along with an 80-yard touchdown return, and he is our Chevrolet Most Valuable Player for Cal Poly. In his name goes $1,000 to the General Scholarship Fund.
And in the name of Mike Zinda, $1,000 to Santa Clara. That was the spiker with the ball as Dave Ramona made the stop. Tell you, Ramona is an excellent linebacker also. He's a junior. And all these kids will be back next year. Mike Zinda is a freshman. He'll be back.
That's
Ramona will be back. Mark McAtee, the outside linebacker, will be back. Dave Padilla, the nose guard, will be back for Santa Clara. Greg O'Leary, the defensive tackle, will be back. Chris Lundy back. Second down. 6 yards to go. But for Cal Poly, they've got next week for the championship. Nelson gives to number 30, Jim Colvin.
Hey, I'm impressed with Lloyd Nelson. While we were talking about our Chevy players, Lloyd Nelson was kind of running wild down here. You know that?
Lloyd Nelson, just a sophomore out of San Bernardino. What great direction by Lou Volpicelli, the man who started ABC Sports. Got a fellow by the name of Rune Arledge involved. But Lou Volpicelli, the man who is responsible for ABC Sports.
He is some kind of player.
Not to mention our producer, Doug Wilson.
And he's a hoss and a half.
38 seconds left to play. Third down, 3 yards to go. The give. Again to number 30, Colvin. There's a flag down back at the line of scrimmage as Colvin takes it down to the 35-yard line. I'd also like to take this opportunity to thank Steve Gale, who's done an absolutely sensational job teaching stats for us up here in the booth, and Denny Martindale, who's been our spotter. Thanks, guys. A superb job. 26 seconds left to play. Illegal motion against Cal Poly.
Okay.
And I'll tell you, it is getting real dark here in San Luis Obispo.
I'll thank those guys, too, and I'll thank you for a nice day.
Lee, enjoyed thank you very much. You. Real super job. Lee Groskup, an All-American quarterback at the University of Utah. I told you at the top of the show I followed him in there, but I never could follow in his footsteps.
Yeah, but you made it to the Liberty Bowl.
I made it to the Liberty Bowl. But you made it to the All-American team. Third down, long yardage now for Lloyd Nelson. 21 seconds left to play. This is probably the last play of the ball game as Cal Poly turned the game around. They had a 10-point lead at the half, and they turned it around as you look at Joe Harper, the man with the smile. Now the clock is running. They probably won't even get this play off. 5 seconds left to play. They're counting it down. 3-2-1. That's the ball game here at Cal Poly, San Luis Obispo. The fans run out of the field. There's the, look at that. They carry the coach off the field. Cal Poly going to the national championship. We'll be back with the final word as you see the final score. By Doug Wilson, the man who brought you the outstanding ice skating at the Winter Olympics in Lake Placid. Directed by Lou Volpicelli. What a great. The technical director, Ernie Buttleman. The associate director, Bob Lanning. Now, this is Ted Dawson, along with Lee Groskup, saying so long from Mustang Stadium in San Luis Obispo, California. NCAA College Football. Santa Clara versus Cal Poly has been brought to you by Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis Brewers of Michelob, put a little weekend in your week. By Mr. Goodwrench in the General Motors Parts Division, who help you keep that great GM feeling with genuine GM parts. By Westinghouse and the 140,000 Westinghouse employees worldwide. And by the men and women of the Bell System, keeping your communication system the best in the world. Once again, the final score today was 38-14, Cal Poly winning it. Travel arrangements made through and a promotional fee paid by United Airlines. United flies more people to Hawaii than any other airline. That's what friendly skies are all about. This has been a presentation of ABC Sports.